the first thing we have to deal with is a committee appointed by Supreme Court. Justice Mittal Committee, Geeta Mittal Committee on Manipur Violence. Supreme Court appointed this committee in the wake of the Manipur violence. We know a bit of the chronology of Manipur violence already, why it happened. But it, remember, it is an interim report. We are not very clear what will be represented. As soon as the final report comes, और ये भी नहीं पता लगेगा कि final report will be in public domain or not. ये भी clear नहीं है अभी. Because chances are, if it will be sensitive, if it will contain some sensitive information, it is not likely to be made public. So let's see if it is made public or not. But nonetheless, let's see the Manipur violence. Why it happened, we know. There was a very simple thing called ST reservation. So for that, we need to remember the constitutional provision first. Important for prelims. UPSC may understand one thing. If something is being in mains, sorry, in interview. Arey, kya bol raha hu main? So if something is in current affairs, so it becomes important for mains and interview. Particularly interview may understand the UPSC members. They are not preparing like you. So they may or may not have idea about what is actually the syllabus. Whatever they see in the current affairs, they ask questions to you based on that, putting you in the situation. And they love political questions there. Mains and prelims, no political question whatsoever. But interview, political question are must. The reason being, because you will serve the state. And as IAS, IPS particularly, you will be in a political setup. So they want to see how you will reciprocate, behave in a particular scenario of a political output. Okay, so that may become important. Understand here, there is an article called Article 366. You have to remember this article of the Constitution. It says that scheduled tribes means such tribes or tribal community as are declared under Article 342. So 366 says, the tribes which are declared under 342 are the scheduled tribes as declared. So how? Article 342 states that president may, with respect to any state or union territory or where it is a state, after consultation with governor, by a public notification, specify tribes or tribal communities as scheduled tribe. So who decides the scheduled tribes? President, remember that, no one else except president for both the union as well as the state. Now what is the procedure? That is on the next page. The simple procedure is, the process to include the tribes in ST list begins with recommendation from respective state government. So it all starts with the state government for state list. What state government does? State government gives recommendation that these tribes can be included in the scheduled tribe list to the tribal affairs ministry. This is the union ministry of tribal affairs, and which reviews and send the recommendation to registrar general of India for approval. So state sends to tribal ministry sends to registrar general of India, which after approval forward that to national commission for scheduled tribes. It's a constitutional commission and the most powerful one. If you look at all the constitutional commission, then this is a commission you can say is literally very powerful. But at this point, remember a general rule of governance. Nobody whatsoever, constitutional or otherwise, has the power to prosecute on its own. It can at most recommend to the government. This is a general for everybody, be it National Commission for SC, ST, OBC, National Human Rights Commission, any commission you pick, whether constitutional, legal or whatever. None of them can order the government for something. All of them can recommend the government for something. Then it is at the will of the government to implement it or not. However, we have given them a special power, particularly commissions like this, that they can ask the government action taken report. They recommend, and after some time they can ask the government what you have done. Beyond that, they cannot do anything. Ab let's suppose government is not implementing the recommendation of a commission. Kya kar sakti hai commission? Kuch kar sakti hai iske bare mein? Legally speaking, no. But there is something we call judiciary. What it can do is, it can go to high courts and supreme courts and ask them to order the government to do something. This is something they can do. सबको समझ में आया? तो प्लीज रिमेंबर, इट्स अ जनरल रूल फॉर एवरीबॉडी. सम बॉडीज आर मोर पावरफुल, सम बॉडीज आर लेस पावरफुल, बट दिस इज जनरल रूल दैट नन ऑफ देम कैन ऑर्डर एनीथिंग टू द गवर्नमेंट. दे कैन एटमोस्ट रिकमेंड समथिंग टू द गवर्नमेंट. इफ गवर्नमेंट डज नॉट ओबे, द एटमोस्ट दे कैन डू इज गो टू द सुप्रीम कोर्ट और हाई कोर्ट, आस्किंग देम टू ऑर्डर द गवर्नमेंट टू डू समथिंग. But that too, if they feel that some of the fundamental rights are literally violated. In provision mein nahi ja sakti. Because understand, there is something called welfare provision, something called fundamental rights. Fundamental rights are your claim against the state. Because you signed a contract called Constitution of India. In that contract, you said all the powers are with the state. Then I want limitations on your power. And those limitations on power are called rights. So fundamental rights if are violated, then these commission can go to courts and ask them, please order the government to do something. Otherwise, for welfare provision, they cannot, because court cannot order any welfare provision. Court can protect your fundamental rights, but court cannot say to the government, give this person job, give this person reservation, give this person a exclusive seat in metro. Ye sab wo nahi kar sakta. Please remember this distinction. Courts can order to enforce fundamental right, not affirmative actions. But a court ye kar sakta hai, it can make sure if government take an affirmative action, there shall be no discrimination. If government says I will provide food, so government cannot provide food based on religion, caste, class, sex or place of birth. Sabko samajh mein aaya? Please remember these distinctions constitutionally speaking. So this is the procedure. State government recommends to tribal affairs ministry, tribal affairs ministry to Registrar General, and then to National Commission for Scheduled Tribe. Finally, it goes to the Union Cabinet, and Union Cabinet approves. Up now comes the question: once the list is prepared, who will add or delete the entries? Who do that? Parliament. No, please remember this. मैं फिर बता रहा हूँ. To once a list is made already, confirmed made. After that, making a list is up to President. But once the list is made, if you want to add anyone or remove anyone from the list, the only person who can do this is Parliament of India. Clear hai? To make the list, who can make the list? President for state and union. But who can amend the list? Parliament of India. Okay, please remember this distinction. Now after understanding the constitutional background, let's see what happened in Manipur. So Manipur mein what basically happened is there are three communities, particularly tribes, Metis, majorly Hindu, very few are Muslim. Next is Naga, majorly Christian, and Kuki. Okay, these are the three particular major tribes. Within this umbrella, there are numerous sub tribes. Okay, so three to major tribe ho gayi: Metis, Nagas, and Kukichin. Up within this, there are numerous sub tribes. That is not our concern. Remember, only three tribes. What was the problem? The problem was before merger of Manipur in Indian Union in 1949. Remember, it was princely state. So at that point of time, Britishers had a very peculiar policy. They annexed the Northeast India, but they never integrated Northeast in the mainland India. They annexed it, but they never integrated Northeast in mainland India. What was the purpose? To keep these people aloof of national sentiments. To keep these people aloof of national sentiments. First thing. Second thing, what they did is they promoted Christian missionaries. You notice this pattern that majority of the tribes in India, when they left their own religion, because tribal people have a different way of living. They have different sets of values. They even worship land, forest, and other things. Environment mein aap padhenge something called sacred groves. These are the forests which are worshipped by the tribals. But over time, what Britishers did is they infused the Christian missionaries, asked them to go to the tribal areas of India and convert the tribes. You see this pattern, majority of the tribes which converted from their native way, they converted to Christianity. Okay? Just for example, Nagaland, majorly Christian. Abhi Mizoram mein election happened. Mizoram mein the tribes are majorly Christian. Most of the Northeast may you find majorly, except for their native religion, Christianity prevails. The reason being Britishers. Sabko samajh mein aaya? Because if maine aapko pehle bhi samjha, to control the body, you must control the mind first. If you control the mind, the body is yours already. Samajh mein aaya? To control the mind, first you kill the language, then culture. because once you kill the language, the culture is automatically dead, because language is used for communication of culture. And that's why Britisher instituted English based education in India, because when you speak English, you will understand British point of view better than your own point of view, because you don't speak Sanskrit, so you don't know what is written in Vedas. But whatever the Britishers translate Vedas Sanskrit into English, you know that part. Aapko pata hai what is in Vedas, because you have read some English literature which says ki Vedas mein likha. You have not read it first hand. Usme kya likha hai, nobody knows, because remember, interpretation matters. There are a lot of terms in ancient Indian texts which mean something else, but Britishers interpreted them something else. The only purpose was to colonize you, not by physically but by mind. What we call this phenomena, kisi ko yaad hai? Yes, Orientalism. The phenomena of interpreting somebody's native culture as per your values to control the mind of the people is basically known as Orientalism. Jaisa aap India mein, aapko pata hoga, we divide Indian history into three phases: ancient, largely Hindus; medieval, Muslim; modern, Christian. Who divided this? Britishers did. They divided a time into three phases. Balki, if you look at the medieval period, there were so many empires. Maratha Empire was there. Aisa nahi only Mughal Empire was there. There were so many empires, including Hindu empires. But still, a perception is that medieval means Mughal or Muslim. Jabki aisa nahi hai. Who created this perception? Britishers. Clear hai sabko? That's how you colonize. So please remember that Orientalism, very important concept. Essay mein bahut kaam aayega, khaskar interviews mein, when you're trying to make a point. Chaliye, fine. So what happened in Manipur is, Manipur mein the Kukis and Nagas, they have the ST list, but the Metis don't. Metis were not part of ST list. But now comes a question, aaj hi kyun? Why? Haan, yes. Why today, if you have to make this demand and that to this vehemently, that you are bringing a state to a civil war, then there must be a very strong reason. You could have asked this in 1949 also. Achanak se itna pressure kyun aane laga? Because if you remember, economics mein something we study called structural unemployment. Structural unemployment means where jobs are in the market, but you don't have the skill set to match the jobs. So you are unemployed not because the jobs are absent, but because you don't have the skills for those jobs in the market. You have different skills and jobs are of different skills, and economy it keeps on happening. So large number of Indians are structurally unemployed. The prime reason you will study in governance, India's education system is pathetic. It believes in rote learning, clearing exam. It focuses more on knowledge, clearing exam, than skills imparting. That's the biggest weakness in India's education system. That's why if you read any current affairs newspaper about economics, the one complaint all capitalists of India make is that we produce graduated idiots. They are graduate, they have degrees, but they don't have the skills. What should I do with these people? Isliye government of India provides you training. Government job mein aapko 2-3 saal ki training hoti hai. Same goes with private jobs. Private job mein nobody hires you directly into a job. They hires you as a trainee. Jabki ye nahi hona chahiye. You should have been trained already in the college. You should be readily available to work. But aisa India mein nahi hota, because India's education system is skewed. The lab to land connect is very less. Yahan tak clear hai sabko? So you are structurally unemployed. Then what you do is you burden agriculture, because those who cannot get jobs in private sector, they go and they say, are like, we have a farm, let's do this. This is the problem, that India's farming sector is a victim of kaisi unemployment? Disguised unemployment. In a farm household, there are 6 people, all are working on a farm. Jabki there is a requirement of 3 people at most. Those remaining 3 people, if they get employed in some other sector, may manufacturing, services, whatever, so it will diversify the income of the farming household. They will not demand MSP. The reason farmers demand that government provide us MSP as a guarantee is because they are fearful. They are fearful of losing whatever little wealth they have. And the reason is no diversity of income. Entire family depends on a farm. Sabko samajh aaya? Majority of India's farmers are marginal and small. Marginal small definition is less than 2 hectares. Okay, definitions yaad rakhiye, prelims mein kaam aata hai. बिलिम से यूपीएससी कैन प्ले स्मॉल एंड मार्जिनल फार्मर्स मींस लेस देन 3 हेक्टेयर यू आर लाइक हां ये तो सुनने में सही लग रहा है नहीं है द लिमिट इज 2 हेक्टेयर प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट दोज हु कैन नॉट डू द एग्रीकल्चर स्टार्ट्स सेल बिजनेसेस स्मॉल शॉप्स किराना स्टोर व्हाटएवर यू स्टार्ट सम सेल बिजनेस बिकम बिग बट दे आर वेरी फ्यू रिमेनिंग बिजनेसेस रिमेन मार्जिनल दे ईट दे वर्क डेली दे सर्वाइव डेली Of the people who cannot go here, something called disguised unemployment, and here self-employment, those people start preparing for government job because government job has a particular scenario. It requires knowledge, not skill. You pick any government exam, they all check is whether you know this concept. They don't know whether you can know the applying this concept in real life. जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल एस एस सी मेजोरिटी ऑफ इंडिया ब्यूरोक्रेसी आई एस को मैं काउंट नहीं कर रहा इट इज लेस देन 1% ऑफ एंटायर ब्यूरोक्रेसी ऑफ इंडिया The remaining bureaucracy, 99% bureaucracy, are recruited by exam called State Staff Selection Commission. There is a commission of Government of India called Staff Selection Commission, which recruit 99% of the bureaucracy. That people give standard exam, English, aptitude, maths, reasoning, bus. Imagine you are recruiting income tax officer, you are recruiting CBI officer, you are recruiting customs, you are recruiting so many officers and you are asking them, Maths, reasoning, English. What that person will do with that knowledge in his or her field. So for that, government provides training. So that's why majority of the people prepare for government exam. The reason being, they require knowledge, not skills. Private mein ulta hai. Private mein nobody cares about degree. When you will start doing jobs, you will realize this. They literally don't care about degree. They all care about is your knowledge. When you will go to interview, degree bas aap likh doge na, wo maan lenge. If you can answer. They will not ask, show me the degree, main check karega, jaise government check karti hai. They don't check it. They are like, if you have the skills, I don't care. Aap saatvi pass ho, mujhe farak nahi padta. But if you have the great skills, I will hire you. This is a question somebody asked to Anand Mahindra, the Mahindra founder, chairman. So, sir, what was your marks in 10th or 12th, whatever? He replied, the stage that I am in, experience matters, not the marks. The thing is, private mein har jagah yahi hai. Nobody cares about your degree. आप कह लीजिए डिग्री कुछ होती है काम कुछ कर रहे हैं इट्स वेरी कॉमन इन प्राइवेट बिकॉज योर स्किल्स के बेसिस पे काम होता है एंड देयर इज नो लिमिट टू ग्रोथ इन प्राइवेट लिटरली फॉर द रियली स्किल्ड पीपल व्हेन आई से स्किल आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट टेक्निकल स्किल आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट टेक्निकल प्लस सोशल स्किल्स रिमेंबर 90% ऑफ योर ग्रोथ और योर डिमोशन और योर अनग्रोथ विल हैपन बिकॉज ऑफ सोशल स्किल्स यू मे बी मोस्ट टैलेंटेड पर्सन ऑन अर्थ विदाउट सोशल स्किल बिलीव मी यू विल नॉट राइज क्लियर है सो गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स अब प्रॉब्लम क्या आ रही है सिंस 1991 वी हैव नियोलिबरल गवर्नेंस नियोलिबरल गवर्नेंस में प्राइवेटाइजेशन इज हैपनिंग एट अ रैपिड पेस सो द गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स आर डिक्लाइनिंग एंड दैट्स व्हाई इंडिया हैज अ लार्ज अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट सिनेरियो बट अब यू नो द जॉब्स आर डिक्लाइनिंग सो मान लेते देवर 1000 आईएएस ऑफिसर वर रिक्वायर्ड एंड एप्लीकेंट वर 50,000 You won't pressurize. You are like, fine, doesn't matter. Even if 50% reservation is there, they are sufficient job for me. But now there are 1,000 job and 15 lakh applicants. You're like, nahi, bhai, now I need reservation. Understand the thing? Because government jobs are declining. Unemployment is very high. So the people trying for government job have multiple fold. 2010 se pehle, the people who became IAS before 2010 may have faced a competition of one seat pe 6 people or 60 people. You're facing 1,000 seats and 15 lakh applicants. It's too huge. 2010 se pehle, you could become IAS by 1/4 of the hard work you will put in. Jitna hard work aap karenge, uske 1/4 mein aap IAS ban jate. Why? Competition was less, government jobs were abundant. And particularly before 1991, they were everywhere. Literally, there was a scenario, you can ask your parents or somewhere. ऐसा सिनेरियो होता था इफ यू गो टू इंटरव्यू वो कहते थे भाई किसी और को जानता है उसे भी लिया या दो वैकेंसी और है दिस यूज्ड टू बी द सिनेरियो इन गवर्नमेंट जॉब देयर वर सो मेनी जॉब्स एंड लेस एप्लीकेंट्स एक व्यक्ति के पास 6-6 जॉब हुआ करती थी ही यूज्ड टू चूज कहां जाऊंगा ठीक है यहाँ पे उल्टा हो गया है 6 लोगों के पास एक ही जॉब की ट्राई कर रहे हो सबको समझ में आया नाउ व्हेन दिस इज लेस यू डिमांड रिजर्वेशन दिस इज व्हाट यू आर विटनेसिंग इन द कंट्री द अपर कास्ट which never demanded reservation, the upper caste which resented reservation. Upper caste feel that people having reservation are less talented. These people are now demanding reservation. See, Jats in हरियाणा, पाटीदार इन गुजरात, मराठा इन महाराष्ट्र, दीज आर द डोमिनेंट कम्युनिटी ऑफ द स्टेट्स. दे आर यूजिंग दैट डोमिनेंट पावर टू मेक द स्टेट टू गिव रिजर्वेशन. दे वुड नॉट बी आस्किंग दिस इन 1990. द रीजन बींग उस समय में जॉब्स इतनी थी, दे वर नॉट कंसर्न. दे यूज टू क्रिटिसाइज पीपल विद रिजर्वेशन, बट नाउ द जॉब्स आर सो लेस एंड यू वॉन्ट अ बिगर पाय ऑफ इट, सो यू वॉन्ट रिजर्वेशन. दिस इज मणिपुर. तो मणिपुर इज नॉट फार-फेस्ट, समथिंग हैपनिंग इज मणिपुर इज नॉट डिफरेंट. It is the part and parcel of what is happening in entire India. What is happening in Maharashtra, Gujarat, Haryana, virtually any state you can pick. Same thing is happening in Manipur. But problem is that Manipur went into ethnic quotient also. Same thing are happening in other states also. But Manipur went into the ethnic quotient. Oh, why is it so? Because there are three tribes out of which, Metis, Kukis and Nagas. Up the thing is, the Meti dominates. Meti is the most powerful community in Manipur, and they dominate the entire affairs of the state. So, out of 60 seats, there 40 seats are in Meti's control. So, Meti has disproportionate power on legislature. Second thing, economic. आपको पता, if Meti get affirmative actions granted to ST by the constitution, same job वाला scenario. Kukis and Nagas feel, chalo fine, if they control state, they control legislature, at least we control bureaucracy. The reason being, we have reservation, they don't. So we use ST reservation, they cannot use ST reservation. But if they get ST reservation, to puri state pe ST reservation hoga. By teeni to community hai, teeno ke paas ST reservation hai. Then all of them will have the ST reservation. Pata nahi general kahan hoga wahan pe, I don't know. So they are concerned about this. They are concerned about the economic dominance, particularly the bureaucratic dominance of Metis. Third, next thing, Manipuri. Manipuri, that is particularly spoken by Meti, is also the part of 8th schedule of the constitution. What is 8th schedule? It lists the languages of India. 22 languages, which are not national languages. Keep that in mind. They are recognized languages. India has no national language as of today. India has two official languages, Hindi and English. Official means that is used for the communication of government. India has no national language, zero. And India has 22 recognized languages. These are the languages in which you can give UPSC paper. UPSC ka paper means mains and interview. You can give in 22 languages. These are 8th schedule language. Clear hai yahan tak? So Manipuri is in 8th schedule. It means whenever the lingua franca or the national language of India will be developed, Manipur will be the part of it. Manipuri. The constitution says that these are the 22 languages in the 8th schedule. Whenever the government decides to create a national language, they will appoint a commission. In that commission, people from these 22 languages will be there. Experts, linguistic experts. They will create a new language for India. New grammar, new everything. And languages har baar banayi bhi jati hai, todi bhi jati hai. For example, even for movies you make languages. Jaise aapne Bahubali movie dekhi hogi. Jo bhi the, wo faction wale. That language was literally made with a vocabulary and a grammar. Same if you have seen Game of Thrones. Game of Thrones is a US program. For that they make a special language. So aisa nahi hai, language banayi nahi jati. Over time, for if we can make new language for movie and for shows, we can certainly make a new language for a nation. So it can be done in future. So imposition of Hindi is not required. Chaliye, next, eviction notice. This was the immediate reason. Why ethnic clashes erupted in Manipur? The immediate reason was this. Pehle kya hota tha during Congress government? Dekhiye, BJP ke saath is a problem. BJP plays a politics of religion. It tried to concentrate Hindu vote bank. Maine aapko samjhaya tha. BJP tried to concentrate Hindus as a vote bank and divide Muslims and other communities into factions. Congress plays it other way around. Congress plays caste politics. Congress tries to divide Hindus into caste and unify minorities into a vote bank. BJP plays the counter. What happens is, till the time Congress was controlling Northeast, the Congress always used to have a minority chief minister. Even though Metis were the majority, the chief minister was used to be Naga or Kuki. So they never resented the control. They were like, chief minister to humara kam se kam. Even though majority of the people in legislature are Meti. बीजेपी के टाइम पे क्या हुआ, बिकॉज बीजेपी प्लेज द पॉलिटिक्स ऑफ हिंदुत्व. तो सिंस द बीजेपी हैज कम टू पावर, इट हैज स्टार्टेड अपॉइंटिंग अ हिंदू चीफ मिनिस्टर. सबको समझ में आया? तो इट वॉज अ साइकोलॉजिकल डैमेज टू द कम्युनिटी, पर्टिकुलरली नागास एंड कुकीज. They were resenting this power change. They were resenting Hindutva politics. They were resenting concentration of power in the community called Meti. This was the biggest resentment. And recently what happened, as soon as this government came into play, this is a new government, Hindu government, they put on eviction notices. The government since August 2022 declared 38 villages in this protected area, largely inhabited by Kukis and Nagas as illegal settlement. So the second they came into power in August 2022, what they started to do, they started to emphasize the villages in this particular protected area as illegal settlement. So it means those people were started to get evicted. Pehla, you lost your chief minister, which was giving you psychological security. That is the reason I told you, we have a ST president. Why the Modi government made an ST as the president? Because Modi government was too much criticized for favoring the upper caste. Hamesha criticized ki jati hai. So they were trying to signal to the people that we are not only upper caste. That's why they made first SC prime minister, then, sorry, ST president, then ST president. It was a political choice to signal that I am not against SCSTs. पर यहां पे क्या हुआ, यू लॉस्ट. तो वहां पे देखिए, बाय मेकिंग मुर्मू द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया आर ऑल एसटीज एम्पावर्ड इन इंडिया. अब उनके साथ कोई डिस्क्रिमिनेशन नहीं होगा, बिल्कुल होगा. बट साइकोलॉजिकल सिक्योरिटी भी कोई चीज होती है. यू मे बी द मोस्ट इनसिक्योर पर्सन, बट इफ यू हैव अ साइकोलॉजिकल सिक्योरिटी दैट समथिंग गुड इज अबाउट टू कम, यू आर लेस लाइकली टू रिवोल्ट. बट वेन यू आर पेसिमिस्ट, यू फील लाइक नथिंग इज अवेलेबल टू मी, यू लार्जली रिवोल्ट. So they had a chief minister, that's why they were not resenting. Plus, the government was not carrying out these kind of actions. Pehla toh they lost the chief minister, then they lost their dominance over the state by Hindutva politics. Third, they lost their land. Then the fourth and the last, bolte na, nail in the coffin was High Court order. The High Court ordered the government of Manipur to send the recommendation to the union government for including Metis in the ST list. Pehla number, this was not within the power of High Courts. Maine starting mein hi aapko samjhaya, High Courts or Supreme Courts, they can protect your fundamental rights. They cannot order affirmative actions. Affirmative actions are the power of the state. It's a discretionary power of the state. Aap demand nahi kar sakte hain. You cannot go to a court demand that I want reservation. You cannot go to a court demand I want food. You cannot go to a court demand I want water. These are discretionary power of the state. You can demand that from government because you give vote to them. But you cannot say to the court or High Court or Supreme Court, please sir, order the government of India to provide me reservation. Malala Jat cannot go to High Court or Supreme Court and say to those people, ki please order the government of Haryana or government of Union of India, please provide me reservation. Because these are discretionary power of the state, not your rights. So, jo High Court ka order tha, wo galat tha, legally speaking. It should not have ordered this. But remember, maine aapko hamesha samjhaya, judges are the part of society. आसमान से नहीं गिरे हैं वो लोग. दीज आर द पीपल एम्बेडेड इन द सोसाइटी, दे हैव द सेम मोरालिटी एज ऑफ द सोसाइटी. So the all the biases that you people possess, the judges possess. So they also were biased. They were like, chalo Metis ko reservation diya jaye. Sabko samajh mein aaya? Legally wrong order. The Manipur High Court had no authority to say to the government of Manipur, send the recommendation for Meti ST list to the union. Government chahti apni marzi se bhej sakti thi. Ab jaisi ye order pass hua, the Kukis and Naga started a protest. And that protest over time turned violent. How it turned violent? That's come to social media. Maine aapko bataya, the biggest danger to Indians or to entire humanity. There was a particular person from a Methi community. He posted a burnt out girl. She was burnt, wrapped somewhere. And he said that the Kuki community or the Naga community, they raped her, mutilated her and burned her. Jabki she was honor killed in Rajasthan. राजस्थान में द फैमिली ऑनर किल्ड हर फॉर जो भी लव अफेयर वगैरह जो भी सीन रहा होगा. तो द रॉन्ग पोस्ट वॉज मेड, बट इतना वेरीफाई कौन करता है आज के समय में. यू आर लाइक फॉरवर्ड करो, माता की कृपा होगी, हो गई कृपा. So the problem is people keep on forwarding without verifying what is shown in the post is correct or wrong. So they created a wildfire. People got angry. They started, the protest happened. The video came and counter protest started. And those protests turned into a violent clash. Ultimately, more or less a civil war. Who is to blame here? Pehla, the High Court. They should not have set the order. It was the power of the government. If government sent it, it's will. People protesting against the government, they're right. The High Court should not have said it. Second thing, it is a part of a bigger problem. Don't think it is Methi's problem. It's India's problem. This is problem we are witnessing around India. Manipur made went to the stage of civil war. But with remaining state, be it Haryana. Haryana mein baga to kuch saal pehle bahut ganda wala riot hua tha. For same reason. Same reason Haryana mein hua. Gujarat, you can pick any state of India today and you will find the same scenario. The dominant community which controls the state power is forcing the government to provide reservation. So where is the core of the issue? Economy. Unemployment. Joblessness. Inflation. Hurting people. Media not covering it, not showing. There is too much dissent on the ground. Keep this in mind. इसलिए आजकल आप देख रहे हैं politics कैसी चल रही है. पानी free, बिजली free, cylinder free. Even BJP is saying this. The government which never gave anything for free is saying the same thing. अभी Narayan Murthy, Infosys chairman, आज ही आया शायद उनका. He is like government should give nothing for free. होता है होता है. जब आपके पास सब कुछ होता है तब आपको यही लगता है. Government बनाई क्यों हमने? फिर मोदी जी को वोट दिया ही क्यों? अडानी को डायरेक्ट वोट दे देते हैं. या इंफोसिस के चेयरमैन को डायरेक्ट वोट दे देते हैं. ही शुड रन द गवर्नमेंट. दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम. व्हेन यू आर टू रिच ना, डू यू थिंक दैट द पीपल गेटिंग थिंग्स फॉर फ्री आर फ्री लोडर्स? नहीं सर, आपसे ज्यादा टैक्स वो पे करते हैं. रिमेंबर ऑक्सफैम रिपोर्ट. द 50% ऑफ बॉटम इंडिया हैज ओनली 3% ऑफ नेशनल वेल्थ. दे पे 65% ऑफ जीएसटी. एंड दिस इंफोसिस चेयरमैन टाइप ऑफ पीपल, द कैपिटलिस्ट ऑफ इंडिया, दे हैव 65% ऑफ नेशनल वेल्थ, 10% of India, and they pay 3% of GST. So the common people pay more GST than Infosys chairman. ठीक है, तो इसका कहना कि free things should not be there, this is the problem with capitalism. उनको लगता है कि वो ही hardworking है, बाकी सारे बेवकूफ है. This is, you must remember, problem ये किसके साथ है? That's why neoliberalism is known as Pick's philosophy. Neoliberalism एक बहुत बड़ी problem है. Neoliberalism believes that hard work and merit is success. Neoliberalism ke sath problem kya hai? Ye kehta hai ki if you do hard work, if you are meritorious, you are successful. A problem is, maine aapko pehle bhi samjhaya, success is a composite parameter. Hard work is just one part of it. There are numerous parameters. Now imagine a girl born in 18th century America. She wanted Hillary Clinton, maan lete, who fought for the presidential election. She served at very good position in government. If she would have been born in 18th century America, she would have served anywhere. Not at all. Women were not having the right to vote. She was equally talented, but the problem was she was born at a wrong time. The time was not suitable for her success. So she has hard work, she has merit, but she does not have environmental conditions. So the problem neoliberalism has is, it says the people who are successful is because of their merit and hard work. But what has happened to the society in the world is, we automatically assume that anyone who is successful is automatically hardworking. Balki bola kya ja raha hai? If you are hardworking, you will be successful. But the society has converted so much into success paradigm. They say, for example, if you are the most flamboyant person, din raat daru pee rahe ho, maje kar rahe ho, and you somehow clear civil services, to aap koi bhi bhangar pesh karoge na, usse darshan mana jayega. ठीक है, यू somehow clear civil services, whatever garbage you will spill out. Yeah, I used to teach 6 hours, मजे करता था. Your people like, हाँ ये सही बोल रहे, यही करना पड़ेगा, यही मिस कर रहा था मैं, दारू मिस करी मैंने, वरना मैं भी क्वालिफाई करता. The reason is, problem is, neoliberalism says hard work and merit lead to success. But over time, we have become a society which think that anyone who is successful is automatically hardworking. ऐसा नहीं है. What qualification Jaisha has to become BCCI chief except being the son of Amit Shah? What qualification Anand Ambani has to become the MD of Jio except being the son of Mukesh Ambani? These people are successful because they are born in a particular family, in a particular scenario. Sabko samajh mein aaya? Ab isse nuksan kya hota hai? The people who are successful, they become arrogant. because society teaches them, if you are hardworking and meritorious, you are successful. So the people who are successful automatically starts to think, I am successful. It means those people who are not successful are less hardworking. I clear civil services. It means I am very talented. The people who could not clear civil services are idiot. Aisa nahi hai. They may be more hardworking than you. Something did not work for them. Ho sakta hai interview mein gaye the, boyfriend se ladke pahunch gaye. Mind waisi kharab tha. Upar se chairman nonsense sawal puch liye. Aapne bola main ja raha hu, nikal raha hu. नहीं होता है माइंड स्टेट ऑफ माइंड इज नॉट एग्जैक्ट एवरी टाइम ठीक है यू वर गोइंग टू इंटरव्यू सम बैड थिंग हैपन इन द मिडवे मान लेते हैं योर कार ब्रोक डाउन आप पहुंच ही नहीं पाए इंटरव्यू में इट वाज नॉट योर फॉल्ट बहुत बच्चों के साथ होता है देयर वाज अ पर्सन देयर वाज अ किड हु कमिटेड सुसाइड 2020 में इट वाज हिज लास्ट अटेम्प्ट और उसकी किस्मत इतनी खराब ही अटेम्प्टेड फर्स्ट पेपर करेक्टली दो पेपर होते हैं ना तो देयर इज अ ब्रेक इन बिटवीन अब सेकेंड पेपर में ही लॉस्ट हिज एडमिट कार्ड अब एडमिट कार्ड के बिना उसे एंट्री नहीं मिली लास्ट अटेम्प्ट था एंड क्या करें और आपको पता है हमारा समाज कैसा है सक्सेस नहीं तो कुछ भी नहीं और लास्ट अटेम्प्ट का मतलब समझते हैं इट वाज अ सिक्स्थ अटेम्प्ट ही मस्ट हैव स्पेंट 7 or 8 years तो वैसी बात है ऐसी सोसाइटी ऐसे लोगों को कहां बख्शती है उसकी जान ले लेते अल्टीमेटली ही कमिटेड सुसाइड उसने कहा आप मारो मैं खुद मर जाता हूँ प्रॉब्लम हियर इज दैट इज व्हाई यू हैव सुसाइड्स इन कोटा आल्सो द सोसाइटी प्रेशराइजेस सो मच दैट यू थिंक कमिटिंग सुसाइड इज एन इजियर ऑप्शन देन सेइंग टू माय फैमिली पापा आई फेल्ड The problem, it is all happening because of neoliberalism. So the core of the problem we have, Manipur to ek symptom hai. Haryana symptom hai. Gujarat symptom hai. Jo cause hai is disease ka, wo hai neoliberalism. And a society that worships success over hard work. They do not give credit to hardworking people. They give credit to successful people. If you are successful, howsoever bhangar person you may be, you are the God reincarnated. सबको problem समझ में आई? तो this is the cause. Please remember. अब देखते हैं committee ने क्या बोला. तो सबको समझ में आया क्या हुआ क्यों हुआ? Let's see what the committee said. Justice Geeta Mittal committee, which was appointed by the Supreme Court to look into the affairs of Manipur, what happened, why happened. The report is not in public domain as of yet, and the recent report is interim report. The final report is yet to come. So whenever it will come, we will see. और देखते हैं वो public domain में होगी या नहीं, ये भी नहीं पता हमें. So let's see what happened is, the major finding of the report is that Supreme Court should intervene by compelling the next of kin to claim body and conduct lacustrine. क्या हो रहा है इस समय मणिपुर में? People are not claiming the bodies. अब ये बड़ी problem है. They are not committing the last rite. If you're not committing the last rite, you are not letting it go. हमेशा याद रखिए, in any fight, The people who do not forget the fight are the losers. कोई भी fight हो, doesn't matter आपने किसी से लड़ाई करी, कोई friend, कोई boyfriend, कोई girlfriend, whatever. If you do not forget the fight, you are the loser because you will live with that pain forever. The person who forget the fight and move on lives happily. The problem what we are having here is something bad happened. We all acknowledge. A people are not letting it go, and if you will not let it go, you will keep on festering that wound, and that wound will lead to न्यू प्रॉब्लम तो कमिटी क्या कह रही है द सुप्रीम कोर्ट शुड फोर्स यहाँ पे विल की बात है ही नहीं ये कह रही है सुप्रीम कोर्ट शुड मेड इट कंपल्सरी फॉर द नेक्स्ट ऑफ द किन्स टू कलेक्ट द बॉडीज एंड कंफर्म द लास्ट राइट्स लेट्स एंड दिस ड्रामा आई नो बैड थिंग्स हैपन बट प्लीज एंड इट अदरवाइज यू विल नेवर मूव ऑन एंड दिस क्राइसिस विल कीप ऑन गोइंग फॉर एवर बात समझ में आई दिस इज द ओनली रिकमेंडेशन दैट कैन बी सी एंड इट सेज प्रोहिबिट सिविल सोसाइटी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फ्रॉम ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिंग और इंटरफेयरिंग विद द प्रोसेस व्हाई बिकॉज सिविल सोसाइटी के साथ थोड़ी प्रॉब्लम है दैट दे ऑफन इंटरवीन अब सिविल सोसाइटी भी ऑफकोर्स डिवाइडेड है द प्रॉब्लम वी आर हैविंग इन मणिपुर द मणिपुरी द मेतीस दे ट्रस्ट द पुलिस नॉट द आर्मी द कुकीज नागास दे ट्रस्ट द आर्मी नॉट द पुलिस प्रॉब्लम यहां आ गई है वहां पे दे डू नॉट ट्रस्ट स्टेट द कुकीज एंड नागास दे डू नॉट ट्रस्ट द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट दे ट्रस्ट द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट दे ट्रस्ट द आर्म फोर्सेज ऑफ इंडिया अब द मेतीस दे डू नॉट ट्रस्ट द आर्म्ड फोर्सेज ऑफ इंडिया दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडियन आर्मी दे ट्वीटेड अ वीडियो पहली बार ऐसा हुआ है दे आर ट्वीटिंग अ वीडियो दे ट्वीटेड अ वीडियो देयर इज अ ट्रेडिशन इन मणिपुर कॉल्ड मीरा पाइबीज Meera Paibis are the elderly women of Manipur. It was created for good reasons. It was created to fight against alcohol, the social evils of alcohol, child marriage. Uske liye unhone kya kara? The elderly women of the community, they came together, formed a group known as Meerabai B. It's a very powerful group in Manipur. Initially made for good purpose. Ab wo Meerabai B kya kar rahi hai? They are becoming a defense point of Metis. What happens is they create a barrier. Army ke saath ek problem hai. Army does not have women. Ab they don't have women, the problem is how would they handle these women, that too elderly. They start stripping in front of army. Ab wo army kya kare? Kaise unhe paar kare? If they use force, remember you never use force on civilian. You will hurt the cause. Ab wo force istemal kar nahi sakte. Meerabai B creates a barrier and the Metis carry out the event at the back. Same happened in the Kuki Nagas. Sabko samajh aa raha problem kya hai? There is too much division in the state. The Meti trust the state, not the union. The minorities trust the union, not the state. And they are contradicting each other's actions. And this will keep on happening. Isiliye kya bola committee ne? Prohibits civil society organization. Naam nahi liya, par wo kehna wohi cha rahi hai. Meerabai B kind of organizations prohibit them. Prevent them from interfering in the functioning of the state. Clear recommendations. Two recommendations. Interim report ki pehla, force or compel, make law, order, jo bhi karna hai. Force the people to perform the last rites. Let's end this war. Second, prevent the civil society organization from interfering in the state functioning. Naam nahi liya unhone kisi ka, but kehne ka wohi hai. Meerabai B is another groups ki baat ho rahi hai. All sides. Clear hai? Online people, clear this entire news. बाकी इतने डाइवर्सिटी वगैरह आप देख लेना जो भी है. चलिए फाइन, नेक्स्ट न्यूज पे आते हैं. द नेक्स्ट न्यूज दैट वी हैव इज स्टेट वाइज डिस्पैरिटीज इन मनरेगा सोशल ऑडिट. अ वेरी ब्यूटीफुल स्कीम मनरेगा, बट मरेगा. यस, मनरेगा में रिमेंबर that it is the only legal guarantee for right to work. Only legal guarantee for right to work. India mein ek lauti legal guarantee right to work hai, that is Manrega. So, ab isme kya hua hai? Social audit kya hota hai? So, pehle, let's see some provisions of Manrega. Phir hum aayenge social audit pe. About Manrega. So, Manrega basically the major responsibility of implementing rest with Panchayati Raj. Remember this. Manrega is a bottom up approach. Economics jab aap padhte hain to we study something called developmental plans for India, starting with aapka Nehruvian plan, Gandhian plan, Bombay plan, different plans over there. Gandhi envisaged a system. Gandhi believed that India lives in its villages, and if you really want to develop India, you should develop India's villages first. Something he called village republic. Kind of Gram Swaraj. You have to have a village republic. The village should be the development center. But because we had Nehru in power and Ambedkar, Gandhi was executed and Patel was died. Okay, Patel died natural death and Gandhi was executed. So these two towering personality were not available. Agar Gandhi jinda hota, तो हो सकता था ही कुड हैव इन्फ्लुएंस नेहरू एंड अंबेडकर टू ब्रिंग विलेज रिपब्लिक, बट ही वाज नॉट नो लॉन्गर अवेलेबल. तो आप मर गए तो कौन सुनता है आपकी. तो अल्टीमेटली नेहरू वाज देयर एंड अंबेडकर. अंबेडकर हेटेड इंडियाज विलेजेस बिकॉज ऑफ कास्टिज्म. अंबेडकर बिलीव्स दैट इंडियन विलेजेस आर द हार्बिंजर ऑफ कास्टिज्म, तो ही हेटेड. नेहरू वाज इंस्पायर्ड बाय चाइनीज एंड रशियन मॉडल, सो ही वांटेड अ सेंट्रलाइज्ड डेवलपमेंट मॉडल. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस वी अडॉप्टेड टॉप डाउन अप्रोच. At top, you had something called Planning Commission, assisted by National Development Council, headed by Prime Minister. So, Planning Commission used to decide everything, and it used to percolate to the bottom. Manrega, Gandhian philosophy ka example hai, where the everything rests with Panchayat. It is bottom of our approach. Finances come from the center to the state to the Manrega. Pehle, ab ek naya model aa gaya hai, direct benefit transfer ka. Now what government has done, it has pooled all Manrega fund into a source. Ek fund bana diya Manrega ka. Both union and the state government put money there. Whichever villages need the money, they can directly withdraw. पहले क्या होता था, सेंटर यूज टू रिलीज द मनी, इट यूज टू गो टू द ब्यूरोक्रेसी, देन टू द स्टेट, देन स्टेट ब्यूरोक्रेसी, देन टू पंचायत. जाते जाते कुछ बचता ही नहीं था. वेरी फेमस कोट ऑफ राजीव गांधी, आई सेंड 1 rupee 10 paisa रीचेस टू द बॉटम. ही ओपनली सेड दिस, आई सेंड 10 rupee फ्रॉम हियर, 10 paisa रीचेस टू द बॉटम. उसको डिलीट करने के लिए, उसको अवॉइड करने के लिए व्हाट वी हैव डन इज डीबीटी, डायरेक्ट बेनिफिट ट्रांसफर, ऑल्सो नोन एज जनधन आधार मोबाइल, जैम ट्रिनिटी. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एंटायर मनी इज पूल्ड. Now, whichever panchayat needs the money, they can directly access the money from the pool. No bureaucracy involved. Ab aapko kisi ke DM, CM office jana hi nahi hai. Because you can directly access the money. Very good initiative combining with. So please remember this point that Manrega is operated by panchayat, not the state, not the union. Theek hai? Please remember that. It provides at least how many days of employment? 100 days. It provides at least 100 days of guaranteed wage employment in a financial year. But remember to whom? Prelims ke liye bahut important point hai, yaad rakhiye, UPSC plays in language. Wo ye to likh degi 100 days, par likh degi for individual, nahi, for household. Please remember, it provides at least 100 days of employment in a financial year to a household, not to the individual. And government assume household is composed of average 5 people. गवर्नमेंट मान के चलती है इंडिया में एवरेज हाउस होल्ड स्ट्रेंथ इज 5 पीपल. ठीक है, प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वर्क इज अलोकेटेड, अनस्किल्ड मैनुअल वर्क. ये सारे पॉइंट क्लियरली याद रखिएगा. एटलीस्ट 100 इज एम्प्लॉयमेंट टू हाउस होल्ड नॉट इंडिविजुअल, एंड अनस्किल्ड मैनुअल वर्क नॉट स्किल्ड मैनुअल वर्क, अनस्किल्ड है. ठीक है, प्रीलिम्स के लिए प्लीज रिमेंबर. एंड बिफोर मनरेगा देयर वाज सम स्कीम व्हिच वर क्लब्ड अंडर मनरेगा. द स्कीम नेम वाज संपूर्ण ग्रामीण रोजगार योजना एंड नेशनल फूड फॉर वर्क प्रोग्राम. इन दोनों को हमने क्लब करके मनरेगा में डाल दिया. नेक्स्ट, देयर इज लिमिटेशन ऑन मिनिमम वेजेस. इट मींस यू कैन नॉट पे वेजेस एज पर योर डिजायर. देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड मिनिमम वेज कोड. मोदी गवर्नमेंट हैज अमेंडेड लेबर लॉज एंड हैज मेड समथिंग कॉल्ड मिनिमम वेज कोड. तो मिनिमम वेज कोड में यूनियन गवर्नमेंट सेट्स अ मिनिमम वेज, उससे नीचे आपको पेमेंट नहीं मिलेगा. दैट इज मिनिमम. इफ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट वांट, इट कैन गिव एक्स्ट्रा. मान लेते गवर्नमेंट सेज दैट देयर विल बी 100 rupees, मान लेते फॉर 6 hours ऑफ वर्क क्रिएटिंग अ वेल. यू क्रिएट अ वेल फॉर 6 hours, यू विल गेट 100 rupees पर लेबर. तो दिस मिनिमम. स्टेट गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट, इट कैन मेक इट 150, बट इट कैन नॉट मेक इट 99 rupees. सबको समझ में आया? तो देयर इज अ मिनिमम वेज एज डिसाइडेड बाय हुम, द वेज कोड. कौन डिसाइड करता है मिनिमम वेज? वेज कोड. एंड द वेज शैल बी पेड बाय जेंडर इक्वालिटी. ये बहुत अच्छा प्रोविजन है. वेदर अ वुमन वर्क्स एज अ लेबर और अ मैन वर्क्स एज अ लेबर, बोथ शैल गेट इक्वल पे. ठीक है, वेरी गुड प्रोविजन. नेक्स्ट, एंड सबके रोल याद रखिएगा. हु इंप्लीमेंट्स द वर्क? पंचायत. बट हु मेंटेन्स द रिकॉर्ड और मेजर्स द वर्क? स्टेट. हु इंप्लीमेंट्स द वर्क? पंचायत. बट हु मेजर्स व्हाट हैज हैपेंड? स्टेट. एंड हु मेंटेन द रेट्स? रेट्स होता है, डिफरेंट वर्क के डिफरेंट रेट्स होते हैं. हु मेंटेन द रेट्स? स्टेट. तो इंप्लीमेंट पंचायत करेगी, फंड पंचायत देगी. Fund will the panchayat will give you the wages. The panchayat will identify the people who can work. The panchayat will implementing body. But the whatever the work has been done, who will maintain the record? State. Who will maintain the rates of the work? State. Aur ye pata nahi kya hua. State bura maan gayi. ठीक है. एंड इट आई टोल्ड यू ना, इट्स अ राइट टू वर्क गारंटी. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट प्रोवाइड्स अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अलाउंस. इफ यू आस्क, मींस इफ यू गो टू अ पंचायत एंड यू से सर आई वांट सम जॉब, सम वर्क, इफ दे आर अनेबल टू गिव यू एनी वर्क, देन दे मस्ट पे यू एन अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अलाउंस इफ द वर्क इज नॉट प्रोवाइडेड विद इन द स्टैट्यूटरी लिमिट ऑफ 15 days. मतलब आपने आज अगर डिमांड करा है तो विद इन 15 days या तो मैं आपको कोई काम दूंगा. पंचायत, सरपंच, इफ आई एम कैनॉट गिव, इफ आई एम अनेबल टू गिव यू एनी वर्क, देन आई विल कंपल्सरली प्रोवाइड यू एन अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अलाउंस. क्लियर है सबको? वेरी गुड स्कीम. ठीक है, और मैंने आपको बताया, इट इज ट्रिगर्ड बाय डिमांड, सप्लाई बेस्ड नहीं है. So few point we understood prelims level factor sara UPSC twist language. So please remember who implement manrega panchayat, who maintain the works state, who maintain records of rate state. ठीक है and is it a supply led initiative or demand led? Demand led initiative. The state will not give you job until you will come and ask for a work. And if the work is not provided, you must be given unemployment allowance with gender parity within 15 days. And at least 100 days of work is provided in a financial year. All these points are prelims level. ठीक है अब आते हैं सोशल ऑडिट पे. What is this drama called social audit? चलिए सोशल ऑडिट पे शुरुआत करते हैं. अबाउट सोशल ऑडिट देन वी विल कम टू व्हाट इज द इन द न्यूज. व्हाट इज सोशल ऑडिट? एक्चुअली सोशल ऑडिट मींस व्हेन पीपल कलेक्टिवली मॉनिटर एंड इवेल्युएट द प्लानिंग एंड इंप्लीमेंटेशन. दिस इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट गांधी एनवीसेज. मैंने आपको बताया विलेज रिपब्लिक. विलेज रिपब्लिक में गांधी सेड द विलेज विल बी द पावर सेंटर. द पीपल विल डिसाइड व्हाट आई वॉन्ट. दे विल कम्युनिकेट to the panchayat, panchayat will communicate to the state will communicate to the union, and then they will work as the people demand. This is how you should have government. But I told you why we did not have this government, because Ambedkar did not like India's villages. Nehru had a different system. Ek aur problem thi, India when we started the startup called India, ab there were too many problem in this startup. The biggest problem is integration. There were so many princely states. We wanted to bring them together. South mein the language movement was going on. Northeast did not want to join India. Assam, kya naam iska? Jammu Kashmir drama was going on. So there were so many dramas going on. And government thought at this juncture, we should have more power with the union and least power with the panchayat. Panchayat thi virtually. But now we should reverse this. Ab we are 75 years old mature democracy. I don't think anyone want to leave India. They want special rights within India. Koi majorly India ko leave nahi karna chaha raha. So what we should do is, it's high time we should amend the constitution and implement what Gandhi decided or what Gandhi wanted. We should empower panchayat. They should have maximum powers. Kyunki the sarpanch lives in your area, is your friend, is your relative. The sarpanch is near to you. The panchayat is near to you. And above that, we should empower gram sabhas. Gram sabha kya hota hai? Everyone who is in a village, maan le rahe hain panchayat mein there are 5 villages. So every adult individual of that 5 villages can come together at a place and can discuss, debate, and can issue any recommendation to panchayat. So the maximum power should be with gram sabha. The people of that village sit together, decide about their future. Tell that future to the panchayat. Panchayat should tell that to the state, and state should tell that to the union. That's how we should have India today. Clear as abko? This is the reform you can write anywhere. Please remember that. But anyway, so this is a very good initiative. In this, the people, they come together, they monitor, and they evaluate the planning and implementation. कोई सरकार इवेल्युएट नहीं करेगी. द गवर्नमेंट मान लेते हैज इशूड, द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट हैज इशूड 100 करोड़ रुपीस टू बिहार फॉर सम मनरेगा वर्क. सो द बिहार गवर्नमेंट विल नॉट इवेल्युएट वेदर दोस वर्क हैज हैपेंड और नॉट. कोई डीएम वहां जाके चेक नहीं करेगा. कौन चेक करेगा? लोग खुद चेक करेंगे. कैसे चेक करेंगे? यू कैन फॉर्म एनजीओस, यू कैन फॉर्म अ कलेक्टिव ग्रुपिंग. And then you will get registered with the government that we are an NGO and we are likely to evaluate the proposal in this. Gram Sabha bhi ye kaam kar sakti hai. Manrega mein Gram Sabha ke paas ye power hai. The Gram Sabha of a village or of number of villages, they will come together and they will see ki how much money came for Manrega, how much work was given, kitna hua, kitna nahi hua. Everything Gram Sabha will do. And this is called social order. Very, very, very beautiful initiative. Clear? Ab ise dekh lete hain. It was initially started in Andhra Pradesh. 2012-13 mein start hua tha. Halaki Manrega Act mein it was already present. Manrega Act I think 2005 mein pass hua tha. Manmohan Singh government. So it was already present in Manrega Act, but it was not very much implemented. First it was started by Andhra Pradesh. Over time various states started, because Andhra Pradesh mein jab ise implement kiya gaya, they found literal improvement. They found people, they found that leakages decreased, corruption decreased. Because when people have an eye on the work, they make sure work is being done. और अर्बन लोगों की तरह रूरल एरियाज इतने ग्रीडी नहीं होते. दिस इज अ डिफरेंस यू विल फाइंड इन रूरल पीपल एंड अर्बन पीपल. दे आर लेस ग्रीडी देन द अर्बन पीपल. अर्बन पीपल में ग्रीड करप्शन कुछ ज्यादा भरा हुआ है, ज्यादा पढ़े लिखने होने का नुकसान. दिस इज अ थिंग अबाउट नॉलेज. इट इज सैड नॉलेज एम्पलीफाइज योर कैरेक्टर. इफ यू आर बैड यू विल बिकम सेटन, इफ यू आर गुड यू विल बिकम गॉड. दैट इज व्हाट नॉलेज डज, इट एम्पलीफाइज योर कैरेक्टर. मान लेते हैं आप बहुत ही काइया के लोग हो, तो वट यू वॉन्ट टू डू अ गुड करप्शन. पढ़े लिखे नहीं हो तो छोटा मोटा करोगे, पढ़े लिखे हो जाओगे तो बड़ा करोगे, पर करोगे जरूर. बट इफ यू आर अ गुड कैरेक्टर, पढ़े लिखे नहीं हो तो यू विल ट्राई टू प्रोटेक्ट सम पीपल, थोड़ा बहुत कर पाओगे. बट इफ यू आर लिटरेट, यू आर अ लॉयर, यू कैन गो टू कोर्ट, फाइल पिटीशन एंड प्रोटेक्ट पीपल. सो नॉलेज के बारे में एक बात बोली जाती है, नॉलेज ऑलवेज एम्पलीफाइज योर कैरेक्टर. इफ यू आर बैड इट विल मेक यू सेटन, इफ यू आर गुड इट विल मेक यू गॉड. नॉलेज इज दैट थिंग एंड दैट्स व्हाट वी आर डूइंग. With social audit, you are empowered with knowledge because you can see what is happening. You will evaluate what fund came, to whom it went, what was done, how much it is completed. You approve everything. This is a very good provision of social audit. When it was done in Andhra Pradesh, the outcomes were very praising. Based on that, Ministry of Rural Development issued guidelines to all states saying, implement social audit in as many government schemes as you can. तो आंध्र प्रदेश ने करके दिखाया कि इट वॉज वेरी इनोवेटिव एंड इट वॉज वेरी गुड. इट डील्ड विद करप्शन लीकेजेस. तो उसके बाद मिनिस्टर रूरल डेवलपमेंट इशूड ऑर्डर्स टू द स्टेट, गाइडलाइंस. ऑर्डर तो नहीं कर सकती क्योंकि फेडरल सिस्टम है हमारा. दे इशूड गाइडलाइंस एंड सेड प्लीज इंप्लीमेंट दिस इन एज मेनी स्कीम एज पॉसिबल. राइट नाउ इट इज ऑल्सो इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन मिड डे मील. तो मिड डे मील इन विच द गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड्स यू फूड इन गवर्नमेंट स्कूल्स, इट इज ऑल्सो पंचायत रन इनिशिएटिव. याद रखिएगा, ठीक है, सबको मतलब हर स्टेट में नहीं है, कुछ स्टेट में पंचायत को पावर नहीं दी गई है, नॉनetheless कुछ स्टेट में है. सो दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव. आई टोल्ड यू हु इज एंटाइटल्ड फॉर सोशल ऑडिट इन मनरेगा. ग्राम सभा सोशल ऑडिट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस गवर्नेंस के लिए. अब आते हैं न्यूज, नहीं टास्क फोर्स देख लेते हैं. रिसेंट में नीति आयोग अपॉइंटेड अ टास्क फोर्स ऑन सोशल ऑडिट टू सी द रेलिवेंस ऑफ सोशल ऑडिट इन टूडेज इंडिया. The task force gave this recommendation, which you can write anywhere. It gave a unanimous recommendation to strengthen social audit. It said that people should audit the functioning of government. Remember, corruption happens when the people do not know what is happening in the government. Kitna paisa aaya, kis pe aaya, kidhar gaya. If they cannot see it, they cannot hold you to account. Agar unhe pata hoga how much money is coming to the DM office, they can keep that DM to account. पैसा खत्म हुआ तो प्रोटेस्ट. एंड वैसे भी रूरल एरिया में सॉलिडारिटी ज्यादा होती है अर्बन एरियाज के मुकाबले में. अर्बन एरियाज में तो आपका नेबर नहीं जानता आप कौन है, ठीक है. रूरल एरियाज में गांव के दूर दूर तक एवरीवन नोज हु यू आर. दे हैव अ वेरी कलेक्टिव काइंड ऑफ लिविंग. आपका विलेज डिफरेंट होगा, मैं आपके विलेज की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ, बट जनरली इट इज फाउंड. सो इट इंक्रीजेस पीपल्स, व्हाट दिस कमीशन यूनानिमसली सेड, इट इंक्रीजेस पीपल्स पार्टिसिपेशन, एनहांसेस क्वालिटी ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी. ये मैंने आपको समझाया था मणिपुर एग्जाम्पल. रिमेंबर, इफ यू फील द गवर्नमेंट इज योर्स, इवन इफ यू आर सफरिंग, यू विल नॉट रिवोल्ट. व्हेन यू सी गवर्नमेंट इज फार अवे फ्रॉम यू, देन यू डू नॉट केयर एनी वे एंड यू स्टार्टेड टू फील एलियनेटेड. इसलिए आप नोटिस कीजिए, वेयर एवर यू हैव ट्राइबल एरियाज, ट्राइबल एरियाज, नक्सल एरियाज, दे आर द नोटा इज द मोस्ट प्रेस्ड बटन. वोटिंग लिस्ट में यू हैव अ नोटा. नोटा मीन्स नन ऑफ द अबव. इफ यू यूज द यूसेज ऑफ नोटा, द मैक्सिमम इट इज वेयर इन ट्राइबल एरियाज एंड नक्सलाइट्स एरियाज. व्हाट इट हाइलाइट्स, द पीपल एट दैट एरिया आर एंग्री विद गवर्नमेंट एंड दे आर एंग्री विद एवरी पार्टी. बस मैं नोटा का यूज ये बताता है ऐसे इलाकों में, बाकी इलाकों में ऐसा नहीं होता. तो गवर्नमेंट अगर आपके पास है, इफ यू फील द गवर्नमेंट, इफ यू फील दैट गवर्नमेंट इज प्रोवाइडिंग यू समथिंग, यू डोंट रिजेंट. And this is a problem that social audit can deal with. That's why he has said that quality of democracy will improve. Baki cheeze to common hai, it will increase transparency, accountability and deal with corruption and minimize leakage. Ye to common cheeze hai. Because more than 50% of the government of India's budget or any state government budget goes to welfare schemes. Jise hamare Narayan Murthy ji bolte hain freebies, Modi ji bolte hain freebies. welfare schemes. So which 50% of the government money goes to welfare schemes. So it means the people should know it's their money, where this money is going to whom. ठीक है, अब आते हैं तो सारा समझने के बाद लास्ट आते हैं न्यूज क्या थी स्टार्टिंग में. After understanding what is social audit, what is Manrega and everything, now see this. Kerala. Kerala, also known as the God's own country, it is the only state. हाँ Kerala है. Kerala is the only state in India with 100% literacy at primary level. Only state in India with better gender ratio biased, but in favor of female. It is more female than male. What it highlights. And it has better family planning also. The total fertility rate, I think, is 1.3 or 4 something, very less in Kerala. So what Kerala highlights? Kerala highlights one thing very clearly. With good and quality education comes everything. Ab UP Bihar mein common cheez hai. What they do is, panchayat mein they have a condition that if you have more than these kids, you cannot participate. Kya jagah pe drama chalta hai? Haryana ne bhi koshish ki thi. You are forcing people to adopt family planning by preventing them their right to representation. It will not work. Provide them education, apne aap ho jayega. Kerala has shown this. When education rises, everything rises. That's why Kerala is also known. Maine nahi kaha Kerala mein problem nahi hai. Kerala mein hai. Har state mein problem hoti hai. Every state has problem, every society has problem. Kerala also has some problem, but those problems are not as bad as you see in North India. Clear. And the only reason Kerala has been successful in doing this is because of education. The only thing you can pinpoint. And that is why Kerala stand out as a sole state. Dekhiye. Remember, Kerala is the only state in India which has achieved isme pura nahi likha hai. It is 100%. Kerala is the only state in India which has achieved 100% social audit in all villages. Means every village of Kerala mein there is social audit conducted by the people in Manrega. So very good initiative. Some states overview, let us see. Top performer Kerala, maine aapko batai diya. It is the only state with 100% social audit in Manrega, nearly followed by Bihar 64, Gujarat, Jammu Kashmir, Odisha and Uttar Pradesh. The worst performer here are Rajasthan, मध्य प्रदेश. देखिए 1.73 लीस्ट क्या हुआ. हाँ टॉप 5-6 में है. नहीं इसमें देखिए पंचायती राज में बिहार का इनिशिएटिव भी बहुत अच्छा. बिहार में 50% रिजर्वेशन है वुमन को लेके. कई चीजों में बिहार में पर्टिकुलरली पॉलिटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन में बिहार में इनिशिएटिव अच्छे हैं. ठीक है एनीवे तो 50 समथिंग है. तो लीस्ट स्टेट इज तो मध्य प्रदेश. इट इज नोवेयर एनीवेयर. तो मध्य प्रदेश इज द लीस्ट परफॉर्मर इन सोशल ऑडिट इन मनरेगा. बट प्लीज रिमेंबर मनरेगा इज अ वेरी नेसेसरी सॉरी सोशल ऑडिट. सोशल ऑडिट इज अ यू कैन से आफ्टर राइट टू इंफॉर्मेशन एक्ट आफ्टर आरटीआई. सोशल ऑडिट इज अनदर की टू गुड गवर्नेंस. आरटीआई को सेकेंड एआरसी हैज सेड मास्टर की टू गुड गवर्नेंस. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू से सेकेंड मास्टर की इट इज सोशल ऑडिट. Let the people evaluate government schemes, not the bureaucracy. Because मैंने आपको पहले भी समझाया था, bureaucracy was made by Britishers for their purpose. The bureaucratic structure we have is very skewed in terms of powers. Clear है सबको? चलिए. I hope the entire news is clear. चलिए अब third news पे आते हैं. ये कुछ पॉइंट्स है वैसे आप पढ़ लेना. मैं एक बार जल्दी से रिपीट कर देता हूं. मैंने आपको बताई दिया ग्राम सभा कैरी आउट सोशल ऑडिट इन मनरेगा एंड अंडर दैट लॉ मनरेगा एवरी स्टेट शैल एस्टैब्लिश इंडिपेंडेंट सोशल यूनिट. इंडिपेंडेंट सोशल यूनिट मतलब एनजीओ सोशल ग्रुप्स नॉट ब्यूरोक्रेसी. दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हियर. एंड फंड्स इक्विवेलेंट टू 0.5% of Manrega. The entire Manrega expenditure ka 0.5% is given to these social units for their working. Very good initiative. And who sets standards of evaluation? Social audit mein, you will take some standards of evaluation. Who set them? CAG. ठीक है, एंड सोशल ऑडिट अंडर द लॉ इट इज कंपल्सरी, एवरी ग्राम पंचायत शैल कंडक्ट इट एटलीस्ट वन इन सिक्स मंथ, एंड द ऑडिट ऑफ स्कीम रूल्स 2011 मैंडेट द स्टेट टू एस्टैब्लिश इंडिपेंडेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सोशल ऑडिट यूनिट एंशोरिंग ऑटोनॉमी प्रिवेंटिंग कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट एंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट आउटसोर्सिंग टू एनजीओस। ठीक है, अच्छे प्रोविजन है, याद रखिएगा। चलिए नेक्स्ट न्यूज पे आते हैं। व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट न्यूज? रेयर डिजीज, रेयर डिजीज। सो देर आर सम डिजीजेस विच आर नोन एज रेयर, ऑल्सो नोन एज ऑर्फन। वाई दे आर रेयर एंड ऑर्फन? बिकॉज दे अफेक्ट अ वेरी माइनॉरिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन। इसमें एक चीज याद रखिएगा, द प्रॉब्लम वी हैव इन द वर्ल्ड इज दैट मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द डिजीज अफेक्ट डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, बट द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट एंड मेडिसिन हैपेंस इन डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज, बिकॉज रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट इज अ कॉस्टली मेजर। यू इन्वेस्ट करोड़ जो रुपीज फॉर सम ड्रग कैंडिडेट एंड देयर इज नो गारंटी यू विल गेट अ ड्रग आउट ऑफ इट। कई बार क्या होता है, यू स्पेंड हंड्रेड ऑफ करोड़ रुपीज एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द डे यू फाइंड नथिंग। रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट इज अ कॉस्टली थिंग। इंडिया कैन नॉट डू दैट। अब थोड़ा बहुत हम करने लगे हैं। वी हैव क्रिएटेड कोरोना वैक्सीन, उससे पहले वी क्रिएटेड डायरिया वैक्सीन, आपने सुना होगा रोटावैक एंड ऑल दीज वैक्सीन वी क्रिएटेड। सो नाउ वी हैव स्टार्टेड क्रिएटिंग वैक्सीन बिकॉज इंडिया हैज सफिशिएंट मनी फॉर रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट, नॉट दैट मच बट ठीक है। बट व्हाट वी आर गुड एट मास मैन्युफैक्चरिंग। देयर वर टू ऑप्शंस टू इंडिया व्हेन इंडिया गॉट इंडिपेंडेंस, एक इन्वेस्ट इन रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट मेक मेडिसिंस, दूसरा that whatever little money we have with such a huge illiterate underdeveloped population, let's manufacture medicine at mass. So we adopted second option, and that's why India is now the world's, I think, fifth or sixth largest supplier of medicines in the world, with around only 1% of world GDP, world support to research and development. Research and development mein hamara support lagbhag 1% usse bhi kam hai duniya ka, लेकिन उसके बावजूद भी वी आर द फिफ्थ और सिक्स्थ लार्जेस्ट सप्लायर ऑफ मेडिसिन इन द वर्ल्ड बेस्ड ऑन समथिंग कॉल्ड जेनेरिक मेडिसिन। जेनेरिक मेडिसिन आर द मेडिसिन विच आर आउट ऑफ पेटेंट। पेटेंट इज अ गारंटी यू गेट व्हेन यू इनोवेट समथिंग सो दैट नोबडी एल्स कैन यूज इट। मान लेते आई मेड दिस पेन फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटी विच कैन राइट ऑन अ डिजिटल बोर्ड, सो आई विल पेटेंट इट बिकॉज टू मेक दिस पेन आई हैव स्पेंट टू मच ऑफ टाइम एंड मनी and I want to exploit the sale of this pen for some years exclusively. India mein we give 20 year patent, but once this patent expire, because 20 year mein hum assume karte hain you may have recovered all the money and time you invested for this pen, after that this pen can be made by anyone. Samajh mein aaya? That is the logic of generic medicines. India jo aap dekhte hain na hamare over the counter medical shops mein kuch bhi aapko mil jata hai, इट्स वेरी गुड फॉर इंडिया पॉपुलेशन, बिकॉज इंडिया में परचेजिंग पावर कुछ खास है नहीं। इंडिया में पर कैपिटा इनकम आई थिंक इट इज अराउंड 1 लाख के आसपास है, मतलब ऑन एन एवरेज इंडियंस अर्न 1 लाख पर ईयर। पर ईयर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, नॉट मंथ। सो पर ईयर 1 लाख अराउंड इंडियंस अर्न इज वेरी लेस पर कैपिटा इनकम। उसका मेजोरिटी इफ यू स्पेंड इन मेडिसिन तो बचेगा क्या। बट इंडिया में एक चीज बोली जाती है, मेजोरिटी ऑफ इंडियंस आर वन हॉस्पिटल बिल अवे फ्रॉम पॉवर्टी। Majority of the Indians, one hospital bill and you are in poverty. And who is to blame here? The government only. That's why we need, मैंने आपको पहले भी समझाया था, we need one hospital for the rich and the poor and one school for the rich and the poor. The rich will make sure that that hospital has the best of the facilities because they are connected, they are powerful. Imagine if the health secretary has to go to the same government hospital a common person goes. They will make sure they have the best facility. Very good example, AIIMS Delhi. AIIMS Delhi mein you find all the facility you can imagine. Par wahan bheed bahut hoti hai. Wo isliye kyunki ek hi AIIMS Delhi hai na. If we will have AIIMS Delhi like institute everywhere. Kyunki AIIMS Delhi mein kaun jata hai? Prime Minister and Presidents go there. And because of this, AIIMS Delhi has all facilities. I am not saying it does not lack facilities. I am saying relative to every hospital in India, it has all the facilities. गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल क्लियर है, तो सेम वी कैन हैव फॉर एवरी हॉस्पिटल। यहां तक क्लियर है? So this is the basic up aate hai rare disease pe. Why I'm telling you this? Because rare disease are the diseases which affect a very minute population. It is so minute that it provides no incentive to a capitalist to invest in research and development. Sabko samajh rahe hai, rare disease. Very few people get affected, and because of this, those few people do not have, even if they have purchasing power, it is no incentive for me as a capitalist to research and innovate on that medicine. When aapko socho corona ki vaccine humne ek saal mein bana li, dengue ki vaccine aaj bhi nahi ban payi hai. Uska ek dengue vaccine karke ek abhi aaya hai, WHO ne banaya hai, but wo abhi trial basis pe chal raha hai. Sochiye, dengue why? Because dengue affect whom? Tropical countries. Rich countries ko dengue se effect nahi padta because they are temperate country. Temperate countries mein they are not found and they have very good conditions also. Dengue affects only developing countries, particularly India has the highest burden and people do not have purchasing power, and I am a capitalist, I want profit, so I will not invest in dengue vaccine. Isliye to we have made WHO, World Health Organization, it research and development on the vaccines medicine for poor countries. Sabko samajh mein aaya? This is the problem with rare disease, because it affects so less of a population that nobody cares. तो अगर आपको ये डिजीज होगी तो आपको मरना तय है, बिकॉज़ मेडिसिन है ही नहीं. ठीक है, क्लियर है, दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम. पर नंदलेस हमारे पास एक चीज, जैसे बोलते हम सरकार और इंफोसिस चेयरमैन कुछ भी बोले, पर सरकार का काम होता है टू वर्क फॉर द पीपल फॉर हुम नोबडी वर्क्स. फॉर दिस वी हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्री. सो हेल्थ मिनिस्ट्री हैज बीन इंश्योरिंग अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ जेनरिक ड्रग्स टू फैसिलिटेट केयर एंड ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ फोर मेडिकल कंडीशन. ये कुछ आपके पास है, टायरोसिनेमा टाइप 1, गॉचर्स डिजीज, विल्सन डिजीज एंड जो भी इसका नाम है. ठीक है, डेड डिजीज. तो रेयर डिजीज मैंने आपको समझाई दिया, दीज आर ऑर्फन डिजीज, दे पोज अ यूनिक चैलेंज. देखिए, दीज आर, ऐसा नहीं है दीज आर नॉन ट्रीटेबल, दे कैन बी ट्रीटेबल, पर प्रॉब्लम ये कोई इस पर रिसर्च ही नहीं करना चाह रहा. इट अफेक्ट सो लेस ऑफ अ पॉपुलेशन, नोबडी केयर्स, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट अ गुड मार्केट. अब मैं करोड़ों रुपए लगा के आई मेक अ मेडिसिन और वैक्सीन टू ट्रीट डिजीज, एंड कितने लोग खरीदेंगे? तीन लोग, चार लोग, पांच लोग. सो इट डज नॉट गिव मी एनी इंसेंटिव. सो हु कैन डू दिस? गवर्नमेंट. पर नंदलेस अभी ये प्रॉब्लम चल रहा है. इट इज बेसिकली अ डिबिलिटेटिंग लाइफ लॉन्ग कंडीशन दैट अकर्स इनफ्रीक्वेंटली. इट द प्रेवलेंस, द स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ ऑर्फन और रेयर डिजीज, बस ये याद रखिएगा, अकॉर्डिंग टू WHO, एनी डिजीज दैट अफेक्ट लेस देन 1 person पर 1000 is known as rare disease. Government of India se alag tarike se classify karti hai. According to Government of India, any disease that affect less than 100 patient per lakh is a rare disease. To bas ye definition yaad rakhiyega, less than 1 person per 1000 is a rare disease for WHO. For India it is 100 or less than 100 per lakh. Theek hai, problems wahi hai jo maine aapko samjhai diya. Kuch example jo humne dekhe, क्या है ये टायरोसिनेमा टाइप 1? इट्स अ रेयर ऑटोसोमल, जीन्स होते हैं आपके ऑटोसोम्स वगैरह, साइंस एंड टेक में देख लेना. ऑटोसोमल रिसेसिव जेनेटिक मेटाबॉलिज्म डिसऑर्डर, डिफिशियंसी ऑफ द एंजाइम. ये कोई एंजाइम होता है, इसकी डिफिशियंसी होती है. इट इंपैक्ट्स योर लिवर सिस्टम. तो दारू नहीं पी पाओगे तुम लोग इसमें. ठीक है, एंड विच इट इफेक्ट्स स्प्लीन, लिवर एंड bone. The Gaucher's disease, Wilson's disease, it's a all genetic hai. It impacts copper in organ. It lead to an enhancement of copper in organ, particularly your liver, brain and cornea. So these are the different organs they impact. What is the status of rare disease in India? There are around 450. India mein there are around 450 rare disease, with 80% of the affected population is having 350 rare disease. India mein cases are around 80 to 96. Figures yaad mat rakhiye, but generally yaad rakhiye around 400 disease hai. Itna yaad rakhna bas. That there are around 400 disease, rare disease in India. Bas, that's it. Baki ye figures kuch mat yaad rakhiye, but ye zaruri yaad rakhiyega. That there are around 400 disease in India, out of which around 80% are genetic. Bas ye do cheeze yaad rakhni hai. Teesri cheez, that less than 5% of them has any therapy. बाकी में आपको हुई तो आपका टपकना तय है, ठीक है। तो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम वी हैव, और क्यों है प्रॉब्लम मैंने आपको समझाई दिया था। इसके लिए गवर्नमेंट इनिशिएटिव क्या है, सो इफ फिगर्स में समझ में आया क्या याद रखना है, प्लीज रिमेंबर दैट देयर आर अराउंड 400 रेयर डिजीज मोर और लेस, आउट ऑफ विच 80% आर जेनेटिक एंड फॉर लेस देन 5% वी हैव अ क्योर और थेरेपी, दैट्स इट। बाकी फिगर्स काम के नहीं है। गवर्नमेंट इनिशिएटिव में यू हैव नेशनल पॉलिसी फॉर रेयर डिजीज, it aims to layer lower prevalence and whatever. Next you have production link incentive for pharmaceuticals, means if a pharma company produce medicine for rare disease, government of India provide them incentives, incentive in form of tax breaks, revenue, income support or whatever is there. Next is CDSO. CDSO, Central Drug Standards Control Organization, this is the body that gives approval to medicines in India. Iska naam yaad rakhiyega, CDSO. This is a body that gives approval to India. And एक और चीज जो यहां mention नहीं है, it issues something called DAPCO, Drug Price Control Order. CDSO issues something called DAPCO, Drug Price Control Order, under which it can control prices of any medicine. It can mandate, जैसे recent में various transplant like stent and all, their prices have been reduced to 10 times. 1 lakh का था, अब 10,000 का मिलता है। Why? Because they have been included in DAPCO. ठीक है, CDSO का नाम याद रखिए, important body है। Last we have is genomics for understanding rare disease. It's a India Network Alliance kind of non-profit organization working for this. So these are some initiatives. So let me summarize this news entirely. Rare disease is a kind of disease which affects a very less population. It does not provide good incentives to capitalists to invest, and that's why governments have to step in. The status in India is around 400 diseases are there, 80% of them are genetic, around 80% of them are genetic, and less than 5% have a cure or a therapy. Remaining are on the mercy of Ram only. ठीक है, ये body आपको पता ही होगा, Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. It basically carry out research on disease and everything. India ki body hai. Chaliye find small news thi. Next, National Pension System. Next is National Pension System. To isme kuch nahi hai. Aapke paas do pension system hote hain. OPS and NPS. Kaun sa chahiye tum logo ko batao? सब ओपीएस चाहिए। आपको लगता नहीं अगर ओपीएस आ जाएगा तो मणिपुर जैसे और इंसिडेंट होंगे? सोचिए, अगर ओपीएस इंप्लीमेंट कर देती है यूनियन गवर्नमेंट और स्टेट गवर्नमेंट सारी, इकोनॉमी में डिस्कस कर लूंगा अभी, लेकिन डू यू थिंक इट विल बी अ डिजास्टर फॉर इंडियाज नेशनल सिक्योरिटी? मणिपुर विल बिकम अ कॉमन प्लेस इन इंडिया, क्यों? अभी तो मैंने आपको समझाया था, द प्रॉब्लम वी आर हैविंग इज स्ट्रक्चरल एम्प्लॉयमेंट, एग्रीकल्चर एंड एवरीथिंग। यू आर गोइंग टू अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स आर रिड्यूसिंग, देन यू हैव ओपीएस इन गवर्नमेंट स्कीम, तो क्या होगा? द अट्रैक्टिवनेस ऑफ गवर्नमेंट स्कीम विल इंक्रीज मल्टीपल फोल्ड, तो और अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, एवरीवन विल डिमांड। अब जो कहीं नहीं भी कह रहे थे रिजर्वेशन, वो भी कहेंगे मुझे रिजर्वेशन दे दो। द प्रॉब्लम इज द डिमांड फॉर रिजर्वेशन विल गेट एग्रीवेटेड मल्टीपल फोल्ड। जो मणिपुर क्राइसिस है, इट विल बिकम कॉमन प्लेस इन इंडिया, दिस इज द बिगेस्ट डेंजर। ओपीएस इकोनॉमिक्स तो चलो बाद में देख लेंगे, इकोनॉमिक्स तो मैं समझता नहीं कोई डेफिनेट डिसएडवांटेज है, पर है। इकोनॉमिक्स का प्रॉब्लम क्या है? दिस इज सेम प्रॉब्लम यू हैव इन आर्म्ड फोर्सेस। आर्मी में प्रॉब्लम क्या होती है? आर्मी में यू रिटायर अर्ली, आर्मी में लंबी सर्विस नहीं होती है, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कारगिल में व्हेन वी हैड अ वॉर एंड there was a problem, a review committee was appointed known as Kargil review committee. Kargil review committee gave a concept called teeth to tail ratio. It said rather than having 10 soldiers with one gun, have one soldier with 10 guns. Kehne ka matlab, upgrade your soldiers. Rather than recruiting more humans to work as a soldier, recruit less humans and give them more paraphernalia. Invest in weapons, invest in ships, planes, rather than only humans. That is what, सबको समझ में आया? This is called teeth to tail ratio. Army में problem क्या है? Majority of the armed forces, burden of the army budget, 50% of the army budget goes to pensions and facility for the armed services. वो आपका इन्वेस्ट नहीं होता, उससे आप ना ही वेपन खरीद रहे हैं ना ही कुछ बना रहे, यू आर पेइंग द पेंशंस, इट्स अ बर्डन. पर ठीक है, दे डिड समथिंग द बर्डन. अ प्रॉब्लम ओपीएस में क्या है, विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड हियर. ओपीएस में व्हाट हैपेंस इज यू गेट 50% ऑफ द लास्ट ड्रॉन सैलरी. द एडवांटेज इज यू जॉइन सिविल सर्विसेज, आज कल सस्पेंशन हो जाए या कल आप क्या बोलते हैं रेजिग्नेशन दे देना. You join today, serve 1 month, give resignation. जो भी सैलरी होगी उसकी लास्ट आपको 50% मिल जाएगा. मिनिमम ड्यूरेशन जरूरी होता है. सबको समझ आ रहा है ओपीएस में क्या है. वट एवर यू ड्रॉ द लास्ट सैलरी, मान लेते यू बिकम आईपीएस, यू वर्क फॉर 2 years, गिव द रेजिग्नेशन, तो यू विल स्टिल ड्रॉ द लास्ट सैलरी यू गॉट. अगर वीआरएस मिलेगा तो वॉलंटरी रिटायरमेंट सर्विस. अब द प्रॉब्लम इज आपने 2 साल सर्व किया, जिंदगी भर पेंशन खाओगे. ठीक है, ओपीएस में भी सेम गोज द प्रॉब्लम. ओपीएस में वट एवर इज योर लास्ट ड्रॉन सैलरी, गवर्नमेंट गिव्स हाफ ऑफ इट एंड यू कंट्रीब्यूट नथिंग. एनपीएस में क्या करा था सरकार ने, दैट वी विल कट अ पार्ट ऑफ योर सैलरी, गवर्नमेंट विल कंट्रीब्यूट अ पार्ट एंड दोज विल बी गवर्नड बाय अ बॉडी कॉल्ड पिफर्ड, पेंशन फंड रेगुलेटरी एंड डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी. दे विल यूज दैट मनी टू इन्वेस्ट इन वेरियस वेंचर्स वेयर एवर दे वॉन्ट एंड दे विल अर्न रेवेन्यू और प्रॉफिट. Based on that, your pension will be decided. So your pension depends on 3 parameters here. Contribution made by you, contribution made by government and market forces. Because wo kaha invest hua hai, kitna return aaya, us pe bhi depend karta hai. So NPS mein your pension is governed by 3 factors. OPS mein your pension is governed by nothing except your last drawn salary. Baat samajh bhai? A problem economic hai. प्रॉब्लम ये है दैट 1990 में वी विटनेस्ड अ वेरी सीवियर बैलेंस ऑफ पेमेंट क्राइसिस एंड इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस वेरी सीवियरली. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सेज आई कैन नॉट अफोर्ड दैट मच पेंशन. बट अब मुझे लगता है ओपीएस इतना बड़ा प्रॉब्लम है नहीं. क्यों नहीं है? बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट जॉब वैसे भी बची कितनी है. प्रीवियसली इट कुड बी अ प्रॉब्लम व्हेन गवर्नमेंट वॉज डूइंग एवरीथिंग अंडर द सन. नाउडेज गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स आर एनीवेयर रिड्यूसिंग एट अ फास्ट पेस. जो बची है गिनी चुनी वो भी कुछ समय में खत्म हो जाएंगी. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस the government op implementing ops may not be a big disaster but will be a crisis, economic crisis. Particularly for the state finances. Jaise aapka isme punjab ka maine example likha hoga, punjab ka dekh lena jo bhi isme. To punjab ke example mein, punjab mein promise kiya tha aam aadmi government ne ops lane ka. Whenever they came to power they implemented ops. Because of this 50% of Punjab government's revenue goes in pension only. If I 50% of the money I will give to my government servant only, तो बाकी लोगों को क्या दूंगा? How will I carry out welfare activities? How will I carry out security activities? How will I carry out security, welfare, जो भी ड्रामे होते हैं, how will I do that? Money. But the bigger concern above that is political and social. We just discussed Manipur crisis. We just discussed there's a demand in upper caste for reservation because they want a government job because they are unable to get a good paying private job. Private mein agar job mil raha hai, it's a very less paying. They're not able to get a very good paying private job. Lack of skills, lack of training, whatever you can call it. So government job pe they are depending. If government implement OPS, then popularity of government job will increase even further. Then this aggressive demand of reservation will increase even more further. Everyone who is not demanding reservation even yet, we can have a reservation chahiye. Sabko samajh mein aa raha hai? Because jobs to reduce honi honi hai. You are living in a neoliberal world and everything is being privatized. So the largest employer, jaise for example, railway mein kafi samay se recruitment shayad, I think 5 lakh or something, mujhe yaad nahi aa raha. 5 lakh or something vacancies are vacant in railways. Why they are not being recruited? I think aapko yaad ho, economic survey ne pondered over this question of privatization. I think economic survey 17-18 tha. So they had a problem. Imagine you have a government PSU, public sector undertaking, which I told you are not government jobs. They are public sector jobs. You happen to work in a company which happens to be owned by the government today. It may be owned by somebody else tomorrow. But nonetheless, you joined that company, you prepared for an exam, you gave the exam, you joined the company thinking it's a government kind of job. Not government, but at least government kind. Now, government want to privatize that public sector. Now, the problem comes is you start protesting, as happened previous month. नो मीडिया कवर्ड, इसलिए शायद आपको ना पता हो. इट वॉज ऑल इंडिया प्रोटेस्ट इन दिल्ली एंड लार्ज नंबर ऑफ एम्प्लॉइज, पूरा रामलीला मैदान भरा हुआ था. नन ऑफ द मीडिया कवर्ड बिकॉज दे आर लिटरली कंट्रोल बाय फ्यू कैपिटलिस्ट और कैपिटलिस्ट डज नॉट वॉन्ट दिस प्रोटेस्ट टू बी कवर्ड. आपको समझ में आया? सो दिस प्रोटेस्ट वॉज हैपनिंग, वाई दे वर प्रोटेस्टिंग अगेंस्ट प्राइवेटाइजेशन. दिस इज अ प्रॉब्लम. आई हैव अ पब्लिक सेक्टर कंपनी, यू गॉट द जॉब थिंकिंग इट्स अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब. Now tomorrow you listen, government is thinking of privatizing it. Ab you come to square one, 5 saal barbaad bhi kare, kuch mila bhi nahi. So you start protesting. So economic survey found a very good solution for this. Something called as exit by liberalized entry. The solution was exit by liberalized entry. This is what is happening right now in India. That's why railway mein 5 lakh vacancies are there and government is not filling them up. Majority of government jobs में आप देखिए बहुत vacancy है इस वक्त. I think 50% of IAS vacancy and IPS vacancies are there. 50% जो cadre strength है उसकी 50% vacancies available हैं अभी, पर recruit नहीं किए जा रहे हैं, बहुत limitations हैं. The reason being, what is the prime reason? The prime reason is government is thinking of privatizing things. Up there are two ways. Either you privatize the company and people protest. Second way is stop recruitment. मान लेते I have a company of 100 employees, government company. What I will do is, I will stop new recruitment. So, इसका फायदा क्या होगा? If you will not join the company or not become the member of company's association, you will not become the part of members protest. You will protest, but as a student asking for a job, not as a person who has a government job. So, new blood is not coming into the company. Old people will keep on retiring. Now, the people who are in between, I will give them VRS. I will tell them, मान लेते हैं यू आर एट योर 35 इयर्स ऑफ एज, तो यू हैव स्टिल कितना 25 इयर्स ऑफ सर्विस. 25 इयर्स ऑफ सर्विस में मैं बोलता हूं, गवर्नमेंट बोलती है आपसे दैट आई कैलकुलेट यू विल गेट रफली अराउंड सैलरी, जो भी मैं आपको पे करूंगा इट शैल बी अराउंड मान लेते हैं 5 करोड़ रुपीस इन दिस 25 इयर्स. आई विल पे यू 10 करोड़ रुपीस टुडे, इसे लो और निकलते बनो. यू आर लाइक ओके फाइन. दिस इज कॉल्ड एग्जिट बाय लिबरलाइज एंट्री. दोबारा रिपीट करता हूं, न्यू पीपल विल नॉट बी ज्वाइनिंग द कंपनी, ओल्ड पीपल विल बी रिटायरिंग ऑटोमेटिकली, द पीपल इन बिटवीन विल बी गिवन वीआरएस विद अ ल्यूक्रेटिव ऑफर. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, दैट कंपनी विल स्लोली श्रिंक एंड एट वन पॉइंट इट विल डाई इटसेल्फ. दिस इज कॉल्ड एग्जिट बाय लिबरलाइज्ड एंट्री एंड वट एवर द स्पेस द कंपनी विल लीव इट विल बी गिवन टू private company. Very good example is telecom sector of India. BSNL and MTNL was intentionally killed by the government by exit by liberalized entry. First they stopped the recruitment, then they started shrinking the company by old people captain retiring, mid people ko government offered VRS, very lucrative VRS. So a large number of people took VRS. Over time company kya hoti chali gayi, छोटी. एंड नाउ टेलीकॉम में यू हैव नो एमटीएनएल, देखिए मोर लेस डेड है. बीएसएनएल है बट बहुत ही लिमिटेड है. बीएसएनएल इज अवेलेबल इन सिक्योरिटी एरियाज एंड प्रोवाइड गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज मेजरली. लास्टली यू हैव ओनली 3 कंपनीज इन टेलीकॉम, ऑल 3 आर प्राइवेट. सबको समझ में आया? दिस इज हाउ यू कैरी आउट प्राइवेटाइजेशन एंड दैट इज व्हाई इन स्पाइट ऑफ हैविंग लैक्स ऑफ वैकेंसीज टुडे, इन स्पाइट ऑफ हैविंग लैक्स ऑफ वैकेंसीज टुडे गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट हायरिंग देम. आपको समझ में आया? अब अगर ओपीएस आएगा तो ये और तेज हो जाएगा. गवर्नमेंट ओपीएस दे तो देगी आउट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल प्रेशर, बट दिस एग्जिट बाय लिबरलाइज्ड एंट्री विल इंटेंसिफाई. ओपीएस मिल जाएगा पर रिक्रूटमेंट नहीं होगा, कर लो ओपीएस क्या करना है तुम्हें. समझ में आया? तो ओपीएस के साथ बहुत सी प्रॉब्लम है. फर्स्ट गवर्नमेंट अंडर पॉलिटिकल प्रेशर विल गिव यू ओपीएस, बट इट विल बी अ डीप बर्डन ऑन स्टेट फाइनेंसेस. हाउ विल इट केटर टू अदर सर्विसेस, first thing. Second thing, the bigger problem of socio-economic unrest. The people who don't have a job, which is majority of India, for them government job will become even more lucrative and they will start. Abhi to wo 2 saal pe pay karte hain, fir wo 4 saal aur pe pay kar lenge government job ke liye. And the problem with this is too much unemployment and most important, too much pressure for reservation. And the Manipur kind of violence will become a common place in India. सबको समझ में आ रही है प्रॉब्लम? ऑनलाइन पीपल क्लियर? बाकी आपकी मर्जी, बाकी स्टेट के ऊपर है, कर दे तो कर दे, ना कर दे तो ना करे. बाकी प्रीलिम्स के लिए ये मेन एनालिसिस है। प्रीलिम्स के लिए बस याद रखना कि व्हाट आर द फीचर्स, कंपैरिजन याद रखिएगा दोनों का। ओल्ड एज में गारंटीज आर लाइफ लॉन्ग पेंशन, इन दिस द पार्टिसिपेंट कंट्रीब्यूट एंड द स्कीम डज नॉट गारंटी। मैंने बोला ना एनपीएस में योर पेंशन डिपेंड्स ऑन थ्री पैरामीटर्स, योर कंट्रीब्यूशन, गवर्नमेंट कंट्रीब्यूशन एंड मार्केट फैक्टर्स, ऑल थ्री डिसाइड्स। फाइनेंशियल में आपको पता है द गवर्नमेंट बियर्स द एंटायर एक्सपेंडिचर, हियर द एम्प्लॉयर कंट्रीब्यूट एंड द गवर्नमेंट मे मैच योर कंट्रीब्यूशन। टिपिकली इट इज अराउंड 50% ऑफ द लास्ट ड्रॉन सैलरी। हियर इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द इन्वेस्टमेंट, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट वर मेड, व्हाट वाज द रिटर्न। इट कुड, योर पेंशन मे बी हायर देन 50%, lesser than 50%, and maybe sometimes equal to your salary. It depends all on market forces. कि जो आपका preferred है, in what it invested and what kind of returns it get. तो हो सकता है कि आपकी salary जितनी थी उतनी ही pension आपको मिल जाए, but market forces पे है सब कुछ। The entire financial responsibility of the government, यहाँ पे आपको पता ही है, आपकी responsibility भी है और government की responsibility भी है। Investment of the funds है नहीं इसमें। We know OPS में there is no investment of fund. NPS में the funds are invested in earmarked investment scheme through pension fund manager. And who regulate pension fund manager? PIFARDA. मैंने आपको बताया pension fund regulatory and development authority. Withdrawal monthly pension continues as per predetermined amount. Retirement के time 60% you can withdraw at tax free. Remaining 40% पे you have to invest. तो बहुत कंडीशंस है एनपीएस में बेसिकली। इसका एक सॉल्यूशन दैट व्हाट आई कैन थिंक ऑफ इज मेक इट यूनिवर्सल। यूनिवर्सल होगा तो ज्यादा बेटर होगा। यूनिवर्सल होगा देन यू कैन टेक केयर ऑफ इट। अभी एनपीएस में एनीवन कैन सब्सक्राइब ऑन वॉलंटरी बेसिस, इट इज फॉर एवरीवन इंक्लूडिंग एनआरआईज। एनीवन, आप वेदर यू आर वर्किंग फॉर द गवर्नमेंट, प्राइवेट, ऑर्गेनाइज, अनऑर्गेनाइज, ऑल कैन कंट्रीब्यूट टू एनपीएस, बट ऑन वॉल्यूंटरी बेसिस गवर्नमेंट में कंपल्सरी हो जाता है बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट बोलती है। सबको समझ में आया? तो वट वी कैन डू इज वी कैन मेक इट कंपल्सरी। इससे फायदा क्या होगा? इफ एवरी वन विल कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट इट विल बी अ लार्ज फंड एंड देन इट कैन टेक केयर ऑफ एवरी वन। तो वट गवर्नमेंट कैन डू, पहला तो कट अ पार्ट फ्रॉम एवरी वन सैलरी, एवरी वन कंट्रीब्यूट अ पार्ट फ्रॉम इट सेल्फ एंड देन पुट अ लिमिटेशन ऑफ मिनिमम पेंशन। जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल एटलीस्ट 40%, पुट अ लिमिटेशन कि व्हेन एवर यू विल रिटायर यू विल गेट एटलीस्ट 40% ऑफ योर लास्ट ऑन सैलरी। और ये तब हो सकता है जब व्हेन देयर विल बी अ लार्ज बेस। ठीक है, अब ओपीएस की बात कर लेते हैं। अगर ओपीएस इंप्लीमेंट कर दिया गया देन हु विल फंड ओपीएस? आपसे ही पैसा निकालेगी सरकार, टैक्स से। क्या करेगी? आपको ओपीएस दे देगी एंड देन द गवर्नमेंट विल इम्पोज टैक्सेस। प्रॉब्लम इज that you to pay taxes already and you will pay more, but the problem is the people who are not in government services, the people who are in unorganized sector, you are getting government facility, they are getting nothing, still they will pay taxes, they will pay your salary basically. So the burden will be borne by existing generation, particularly for the elderly jo retire ho gaye. Aap log kaam kar rahe hain abhi, aapko ops to jab aap retire honge tab milega na, पर तब तक तो यू हैव टू पे फॉर द ओपीएस ऑफ द करेंट रिटायरीज। जब आप रिटायर होंगे तो आपके बच्चों के बच्चे आपका पे कर देंगे। ठीक है, क्लियर है? तो प्रॉब्लम इज इंटर जनरेशनल पैरिटी। एक और प्रॉब्लम ओपीएस से है, इंटर जनरेशनल पैरिटी कुड बी हर्ट। दे मे नॉट हैव पेड टैक्सेस फॉर देयर एल्डरलीज बट यू विल पे टैक्सेस फॉर देम। अब पता नहीं आपके बच्चे क्या पता दे ना दे, क्या पता। It's a long time, 30 years के होके 30 साल आप सर्व करोगे, तब तक क्या बदल जाए समाज में किसे पता है। ठीक है, आपने पे कर दी ओपीएस के लिए पर आपके बच्चों ने मना कर दिया, हम नहीं दे रहे, निकलो। चलिए, एनीवे, क्लियर ऑल दिस इशू? देयर इज नो स्ट्रिक्ट सॉल्यूशन। द सॉल्यूशन दैट आई कुड थिंक ऑफ इज हैव मेड दिस यूनिवर्सल, हैव अ लार्ज कॉर्पस, पुट अ मिनिमम लिमिट सो दैट पीपल डू नॉट फियर इट। दैट कुड बी द सॉल्यूशन, बाकी मर्जी है, जो चाहे करो। लास्ट क्या? नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंसर्जेंसी। अरे यार, कितनी न्यूज बची है भाई। ये लास्ट है, इसके बाद वाली कुछ खास नहीं है, खुद ही पढ़ लेना। ठीक है, नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंसर्जेंसी में लेट मी समराइज व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम। सेम प्रॉब्लम नॉर्थ ईस्ट को, द रीजन ऑफ इंसर्जेंसी इन नॉर्थ ईस्ट इज व्हेन ब्रिटिशर्स एनेक्स नॉर्थ ईस्ट दे डिड नॉट गवर्न नॉर्थ ईस्ट इन अ इंटीग्रल मैनर। दे कैप नॉर्थ ईस्ट एज अ सेपरेट एंटिटी एंड प्रमोटेड क्रिश्चियन मिशनरीज देयर। This was the biggest problem that Northeastern people do not felt them connected with mainland India. You see this, आपको पता होगा वर्ल्ड सॉरी मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री में साइमन कमीशन केम इन इंडिया. When Simon Commission came to evaluate on constitutional reforms in India, the Naga, there was Naga Socialist Council something. So they gave a letter to the Simon Commission, Naga people, that whenever the Britishers leave India, we the Naga will have a separate future. The logic was, they said the Nagas and Indians have nothing in common. Aaj bhi Naga mein, Nagaland mein, you will find walls where it is written, Nagas are not Indian. Indians are not Nagas. So it was a common sentiment in majority of the Northeast. And who is to blame? The British government's intentional policy of keeping it separate from mainland India, plus putting Christian missionaries to convert them. Jaise Nagaland mein, what is the official language of the state? Pata hai kisi ko? English hai. Aur maine aapko bataya tha, if you want to kill somebody's culture, kill their language first. If they are speaking English, then they understand Christianity better than their own native religion. हाँ कई सारी स्टेट में नॉर्थ ईस्ट के कई सारी स्टेट में इंग्लिश ही ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज है. द रीजन इज और भी रीजन है वहां पर ट्राइबल है तो उनकी अलग अलग लैंग्वेजेस है. इट बिकम हार्ड टू हैव वन लैंग्वेज जो भी ड्रामे है. सो दिस इज द थिंग वी हैव पहला रीजन. सेकेंड प्रॉब्लम इन नॉर्थ ईस्ट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया अप्रोच. Why insurgency in Northeast? First to Britishers ho gaya. Second reason, government of India's approach. High-headed approach. Ab understand the problem. Maine shayad aapko Bozizi ka example bataya hoga. 2011 Arab Spring. Bataya tha kabhi? Suniye kya hota hai. 2011 mein, Tunisia is a small country on the northern Africa. There was a hawker, common street hawker known as Bozizi. That person was a common street hawker, as you see in the Delhi also. There was a lady cop. She came to him and asked some bribe, as police wale do everywhere in the world. So she did her constitutional duty of asking bribe. So that person did not have it. So what happened is she slapped him. That person got hurt. And that person burned himself alive. That burning incident unleashed a revolution in Tunisia. The Tunisian government fell and that fire spread through the entire Northern Africa and Middle East. 22 governments of the world fell. A single woman cop, her mistake of slapping a commoner, and 22 governments of the world get down. Kyun? Understand. They say, for example, I told you, you have spent your entire day, you are very frustrated, something happened at home, something happened with relationship, whatever. You have very bad mood. You come to the class in the evening, somebody makes a remark, you are like, up to aaja. Now we have a out and out war. Ab to main mar jaunga, kar jaunga wala scene hai. But if you have a very good mood, very cherishing mood, somebody makes a good comment or bad comment, you are like, haan, theek hai. What happened here? Mood. The people were already angry with their government because these were dictatorships. They were frustrated. They were angry. They were just waiting. The powder was there. They were just waiting for someone to light it. And the Bozizi lighted it. Jaise Manipur mein aapko bataya, all conditions were already there. The eviction orders, the control of the state, the Hindutva politics. It has created the ground. The light to that ground was the High Court's order. Same thing happened in 2011. The Bozizi self-immolated himself. A lot of people who were angry with the government, they came to protest. And one after another, the government of the Middle East started to fell. One after another. 22 governments. It's a big thing. Just because a lady cop's mistake. This is what we call butterfly effect. Butterfly effect. It says when you start something, you cannot know the consequences. It can go in any direction. You start something, for example, you start civil service preparation, ki IAS banunga. Kya pata aap neta hi ban jao? Who knows? You are giving some speech in the class, koi aapke paas wale ne video bana li, phir Bajrang Dal aapke ghar pe aaya, aao tumhe recruit kar lete hum. Theek hai? So, this is, you started something with some other intention, but you have no idea where it will culminate. It can culminate in what you desired, or it can also culminate in something else you could not imagine. Good or bad, both. सबको समझ में आया. दैट इज द थिंग यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इन इंसर्जेंसी. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज अ लॉ नोन एज आर्म्ड फोर्स स्पेशल पावर एक्ट, आफ्सपा. Northeast people call it right to kill. They do not call it AFSPA, they call it right to kill act. The problem with AFSPA is it empowers the armed forces. Armed forces, army nahi, or bhi armed forces, even if state armed forces. It empowers them to use force. It empowers them to use force to the extent of killing someone, even on suspicion. Such vast powers are not available to anyone. जैसे इंडिया में आप देखिए, if you are having a protest, आपने देखा है the police persons have batons, they don't have guns, because imagine you are a police person having a gun, चार लोगों ने घेर लिया, तो आप तो गोली चला दोगे, but problem समझिए, सरकार के हिसाब से आप मर जाओ चलेगा, लेकिन जनता में कोई नहीं मरना चाहिए, because understand you are wearing the uniform of the state, if you fired and an innocent person died, you will invite a revolution. अगर आप मर गए तो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला, ऑनर दे देंगे, थोड़ा पैसा दे देंगे, चल जाएगा. बिकॉज अंडरस्टैंड, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया डिड नॉट ऑर्डर यू टू फायर ऑन द प्रोटेस्ट, बट यू आर वेयरिंग द यूनिफॉर्म ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. सो व्हेन यू फायर द बुलेट एंड इफ इनोसेंट इज किल्ड, द पीपल विल नॉट सी दिस एज अ इंडिविजुअल एक्शन इन सेल्फ डिफेंस, दे विल सी दिस एज एन अग्रेशन ऑफ द स्टेट. आप खुद सोचिए पुलिस वाले की केस, उस पुलिस वुमन को क्या तुनिशा गवर्नमेंट ने बोला था, जाओ ब्राइब लो, थप्पड़ मारते फिरो. शी डिड इट फॉर हर सेल्फ, बट शी वॉज वेयरिंग अ यूनिफॉर्म ऑफ द स्टेट. दिस इज वेरी क्रिटिकल. व्हेन यू आर वेयरिंग द यूनिफॉर्म ऑफ द स्टेट, वट एवर यू डू, द कॉमन पीपल सी दैट एज द एक्शन ऑफ द स्टेट. अब सेम थिंग इन नॉर्थ ईस्ट. नॉर्थ ईस्ट में अंडर आर्म्ड फोर्स स्पेशल पावर एक्ट, जैसे आपने जम्मू कश्मीर में सुना होगा, एक हाफ विडो का कॉन्सेप्ट होता है. हाफ विडो, एक विडो होती है जिसका पति मर जाता है. हाफ विडो आर द वुमन जिनके पति गायब है, मरे नहीं है, जिंदा नहीं है, किसी को नहीं पता. जम्मू कश्मीर का कॉन्सेप्ट है. जम्मू कश्मीर में द वुमन हुज हस्बैंड्स आर एब्सेंट, दे डू नॉट नो वेदर दे आर अलाइव और डेड, दे आर नोन एज हाफ विडो. सेम थिंग, देयर वाज अ प्रोटेस्ट बाय सम नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न वुमन in front of an army compound, they were naked and they had a banner which was done, Indian army rapes us. Ab oh yeah, kaun bola? Are wo itni tez bola yahan pe awaaz. अच्छा सुनिए, तो प्रॉब्लम क्या है यहाँ पे? क्या एंटायर आर्मी रेप देम? या एंटायर आर्मी टुक द पीपल ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर? फ्यू बैड एप्पल्स, बट द प्रॉब्लम हियर इज दीज पीपल आर वेयरिंग द यूनिफॉर्म ऑफ द स्टेट, इवन इफ दे आर कमिटिंग समथिंग फॉर देयर ओन पर्सनल रीजंस, इट विल बी कंसीडर्ड, इट विल बी सीन एज द एक्शन ऑफ द स्टेट, एंड दैट इनवाइट रिवोल्यूशंस. इसीलिए नॉर्थ ईस्ट में इंसर्जेंसी इज कंटिन्यूइंग, बिकॉज नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न पीपल AFSPA को कंसीडर करते हैं राइट टू किल. अब इमेजिन योरसेल्फ, यू आर अ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न, यू डोंट वांट टू प्रोटेस्ट, यू जस्ट वांट टू प्रिपेयर फॉर सिविल सर्विस. फॉर एग्जांपल, यू आर इन दिल्ली प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर सिविल सर्विस. बैक एट होम, योर फादर वॉज एग्जीक्यूटेड बाय एन आर्मी ऑफिसर रॉन्गफुली, अनइंटेंशनली. ही थॉट दैट दैट पर्सन मे बी मेंबर ऑफ उल्फा, जैसे इसका नाम है ये United Nation Liberation Front, NSCN, National Socialist Council of Nagaland. There are so many bodies in Northeast. He considered your father, he was matching something like that with that person, and he was trying to restrain that your father was a kind of civil right movement kind of person. He protested, and in that altercation, he died. So you were preparing here for civil services, now you will prepare for armed insurgency. What changed? An action committed by that army officer out of the will of his own converted into a person who you may become the next most popular leader of UNLF. Sabko samajh mein aaya? This is how insurgency works. This is the difference between a war and insurgency. War mein you have army officer in front of you. You are the army officer. You kill two people. You kill three people. They kill three people. They kill three people. But when you are having insurgency, you are in a uniform and in front of you everyone is in same clothes, civilian. You cannot distinguish insurgent and a civilian. And if you use force, there's an armed force special power act, And if you kill civilian, that civilian, if innocent, is connected with a lot of people. Those people will see that incidence as crime against humanity. And the people who has not decided to join the protest, they will join the protest. सबको समझ में आ रहा है, इसलिए फोर्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हियर. इसलिए गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज अ थ्री प्रॉन्ग पॉलिसी, आप पढ़ लेना, मैं समरी कर रहा हूँ. दिस अ थ्री प्रॉन्ग पॉलिसी. नंबर वन, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ऑलवेज हैव अ प्रोपोर्शनल यूज ऑफ फोर्स थ्योरी. इट सेज आई विल यूज फोर्स बट ओनली टू द एक्सटेंड इट इज रिक्वायर्ड, नॉट बियॉन्ड. नीचे है इसमें, देखिए मैं देखिए कहा है नीचे, इसमें सजेशन में कहीं होगा. ये रहा थ्री पिलर ऑफ स्टेट रिस्पॉन्स में, 17th पेज नंबर. थ्री पिलर ऑफ स्टेट रिस्पॉन्स, नंबर वन, प्रोपोर्शनल यूज ऑफ फोर्स मीन्स आई विल यूज द फोर्स बट टू द एक्सटेंड इट इज नेसेसरी एंड टू द टाइम इट इज नेसेसरी. मीन्स मान लेते हैं टूडे पीपल आर प्रोटेस्टिंग, इफ इट इज पीसफुल I will have the police only, not army. Police and that too without guns. Because मैं फिर बता रहा हूँ, if somehow, because आपको चार लोगों ने घेर लिया और आपको पेलने आ रहे हैं, तब आप परवाह नहीं करोगे कि revolution आएगा क्या आएगा, तब आप तो सिर्फ गोली मारने में विश्वास करोगे. पर you can invite her, आप सरकार की नजर से देखो, it's dangerous. आप मर जाओगे, शहीद कहलाओगे, लेकिन आपने किसी को मार दिया तो आप बेमतलब का revolution करवा दोगे. In that scenario, if people are protesting in an area, I will use police with batons. If some violence is likely to be predicted, I will use police with rubber bullets. If even severity increase, I will have tear gas. Severity increase, more measures. I will come to armed forces only when it is absolutely necessary. When people are having an armed insurgence. This is called proportional use of force. समझ में आया सबको? Depending upon the event, I will use the force. If it is non-violent, peaceful protest, normal police with baton to control the crowd. If there are chances of violence, then they may have a rubber bullet. If there are even better chances, I will have water cannons. I will increase severity depending upon the type of event. This is called proportional use of force. Iska purpose kya hai? To avoid any mishappening. To avoid any civilian peaceful protest में आपने गोली चला दी, बस कहानी खत्म है फिर. You cannot contain that protest then. It is uncontainable. Peaceful protest में गोली चल गई तो सबको समझ में आए. इसलिए peaceful protest में क्या चलते हैं? Rubber bullets चलती हैं, water cannon चलते हैं, batons चलते हैं, guns नहीं चलती है. लेकिन North East में आपके पास एक law है जिसका नाम है Armed Force Special Powers Act. In that, even if on a suspicion, the armed forces can use force even to the extent of causing death, and a lot of people have been killed, and that's why insurgency is not ceasing in India. Pehla step samajh mein aaya, proportional use of force. Jaise maine isme aapko ek example diya hai, isme ye Koka Patthar incident of 2006, yahan pe ek Ajit Mahant karke koi vyakti tha, civilian. He was picked up by the army on suspicion of being linking to ULFA, United Liberation Front of Assam. Assam बोलते हैं इसे. He was found dead later within few weeks in the army custody. The people protested. The police fired to quell the protest. और इसका फायदा किसको मिला? इस पूरे ड्रामे का फायदा सिर्फ इसको. उल्फा को फायदा मिल गया. उल्फा ने बोला, देखा मैंने बोला था Indian army is not here to protect you, to kill you. Same is the region of Afghanistan. How come Taliban come into power within a week of US going out? Because Taliban was successful in convincing the people of Afghanistan that these US soldiers are here not to protect you, but to kill you. Because obviously, baat hai, US soldiers have guns. Or sometimes their guns are used and bullets fired, they kill anyone, including innocents. 5 lakh people died in Afghanistan. And I can guarantee out of 5 lakh, 4 lakh will be innocent. 1 lakh may be terrorists, but 4 lakh to innocent. Hai. Or those 4 lakh may be having 40 lakh of population. They may be somebody's relative, friends, family, and whomsoever died unjustly because of the army of America. Of course, those people will protest. Isiliye they supported Taliban. You cannot quell. Afghanistan is a very good case study. If you try to use hard force against an insurgency, you will always be defeated. When world superpower cannot dominate Taliban, then how can you dominate any insurgency? Isiliye we have a law of प्रोपोर्शनल यूज ऑफ फोर्स, हम उतनी इस्तेमाल करेंगे जितनी जरूरत है। एक बार को हमारे सोल्जर्स मर जाए हम वो टॉलरेट कर लेंगे, लेकिन अगर सिविलियंस मर गए, दैट टू इनोसेंट सिविलियन, वो हमारे लिए टॉलरेट करना मुश्किल पड़ जाएगा। सबको क्लियर हो रहा है? दिस इंसिडेंट क्लियरली हाईलाइट दैट। सेकंड स्टेज इज डायलॉग्स एंड नेगोशिएशन। गवर्नमेंट सेज आई विल गो फॉर प्रोपोर्शनल यूज ऑफ फोर्स, आई विल यूज द फोर्स एज मच रिक्वायर्ड, बट द टेबल ऑफ नेगोशिएशन इज ओपन फॉर एवर। Whenever you give a weapon, come to the negotiation. कल आप हो सकता है, you may have killed 10 soldiers. Next day, if you are on negotiation table, I will talk with you. यहाँ पे इसलिए नहीं कि I am forgiving you for killing the soldier, बस because you represent a cause. आपको मारने से cause नहीं मरेगा। सबको समझ में आ रहा है? Killing a person does not kill the cause, and if the cause is not killed, the insurgency will continue forever. If I kill the cause, everything will die automatically. That's why the second stage is dialogue and negotiation. And the third stage is whatever we will agree on the table, I will implement. That's why northeastern states have high autonomy. Nagaland mein no law of parliament applies without Nagaland's legislature approving it. Same Manipur wagara mein you have an inner line permit. No Indian can enter into these state without the state government's permission. Why we have given this special right to those people? Because if we won't give them, they will carry out insurgency. This is called structural. Sabko samajh mein aaya? You have violence, I will use proportional force, but I will have a negotiation table. Whenever you will come to negotiate, we will negotiate. And whatever you want, I will give you under the constitution called structural change. But only one condition. Give up weapons. Clear? That is what has happened to this Manipur organization, जो भी इसका नाम था. Clear सबको? चलिए. बाबा हो गया बहुत. मेरा भी हो गया. एक मिनट. चलिए बाबा, we'll meet again next Saturday. We'll do.